All right, right here, Crispy. This is the one.
Chris Pastris, joined by Chris Cote and Neil Hendricks. And today, we've got 20 of the world's best park skaters competing for an eight-man final. And when that's all said and done, we will know exactly who's moving on to our first ever world championships of park terrain skateboarding in Malmo, Sweden. To hear how this all breaks down, I'm setting it up to my boys in the booth. Neil, Chris, what do you got for us, guys?
Right on, Pastris. Well, we are hyped. Tell us about the vibe. I can feel the electricity from the deck from all the way up here. Pastris, he's soaking it in there.
Oh man, it's on fire down here, guys. I mean, we're watching some of the world's best park terrain skaters compete. Ronnie Sandoval's killing it. I see Jaws out there killing it. Colin Graham, it's on fire down here, dude. I'm really excited for this thing to get kicked off. And we're gonna see who's gonna join us in Malmo.
Right. All right. Thank you so much, Pastris. Chris Cote here with Neil Hendricks. Got to look back at yesterday. The most savage cut. And tell me if I'm overreaching here. Was that the heaviest cut in skateboard history?
It was the meat grinder. It was one of, there was guys that took amazing runs that ended up like 45th place. It was 100 skaters cut down to 9, and it was so harsh. This is for sure the 20 best park terrain skaters in the world in the semifinals today.
Well, we're super excited about the lineup we have. We've got our Pro Select Park Series skaters and, of course, the qualifiers that came from yesterday. Let's take a quick look back at the very beginning, where this all started. Of course, Melbourne, Australia. We were way on the other side of the globe where we saw Chris Russell start this series with a bang.
Yeah, pulled it out, ended up knocking out his buddy Pedro Barros at the very last second. Then we moved on to Pedro's hometown of Florianopolis, new park down there in Floripa, and Pedro, the hometown hero, took the win there.
Full-on Hail Mary finish for Pedro. Then we had a new face up on the podium, Ivan Federico, the Italian one, came correct at Hastings Park.
The first time that we've had a challenger win a Vans Park Series event. Now, the last qualifier here in Huntington Beach. We're going to set the field for the World Championships in 3 weeks in Malmo, Sweden.
Yeah, so far here, Huntington Beach, biggest crowd. Most skaters entered. We saw women's just the other day. It all leads up to the Global Championships in Malmo. But before we get there, of course, we've got to get through some skateboarding today, and these semifinals are going to be heavy. So this is what it takes to win. Neil, we're going to take a look at Chris Russell, his winning runs down at the beautiful St. Kilda Skate Park in Melbourne, Australia.
Yeah, it seems like it was a world away. We started off in April down at Melbourne, Australia. This is Chris Russell's winning run. Here in the finals, it's best run counts, so these guys are able to try some really, really difficult runs. It's not overall impression where you just gotta stay on. Boneless frontside invert, revert, that's what it takes. We're gonna see if Chris Russell can get another win on the Vans Park Series here today in Huntington Beach.
But yeah, this no, was
no doubt. Biggest win so far of Chris Russell's career a couple months ago in Melbourne.
No doubt coming into Huntington Beach as one of the favorites, Chris Russell, a full 45 minutes of fury. So that's what it's gonna take, staying on your board. You can have three bales in a row. If your fourth run is a hammer, you could get the title. There you see the confidence. And now we go down to Florianopolis, Brazil. This was Pedro Barros' fourth and final run.
Yeah, and as you can tell, this is a completely different looking park. This is one of the cool things about Vans Park Series and park terrain skateboarding. These guys have to be super well-rounded, great all-terrain skateboarders, because all these parks feature different types of obstacles and really different skill sets of skateboarders. This was a lot smaller park. I didn't think this was the type of park that a high flyer like Pedro Barros could win, but you know, when you got that hometown energy, Pedro pulled it out, and the guy that he beat in Florianopolis, who ended up second place, was Ivan Federico. And like we talked about, we're gonna hear from Ivan Federico later in the next stop of the tour.
Yeah, Ivan has made that steady climb from finishing second down in Florianopolis.
Worth mentioning, a few people have pointed out that Pedro Barros is not here in Huntington Beach. Pedro has some visa and passport issues, always a little bit difficult for the Brazilian professional athletes to get over here to America. So Pedro's getting that sorted out, but he will be in Malmo for our finals.
We're taking a look now at Ivan Federico's winning run. And it seems like he did this run four times in a row. Perfect. The question now, did he show us all his cards? Does he have more tricks left in that bag?
Yeah, you know, Ivan doesn't have the biggest bag of tricks. He just does all of his tricks every time and does it really, really well. I'm curious to see if the, you know, when he showed up at Florianopolis in Vancouver, he blew the judges away. Now that the judges have seen all of his tricks, is he still gonna be able to make that impact that he had here in Huntington Beach?
You know, he had a similar run through the qualifiers yesterday, but you could just tell the judges maybe being a little bit more critical on seeing the same, the backside flips, the same landing and disaster, kind of the similar runs throughout the last two contests. We'll see if Ivan Federico can switch things up. Here's a look at today's schedule. Semifinals, heats 1 through 4. Then we're gonna take the top 8 skaters. So we mentioned yesterday, we went from 100 all the way down to 9. So on paper, you might think, oh, maybe it's a little easier today. Well, I'll tell you what, absolutely no way. The story here is we have now the best Park Series Select Pros in the park. That's when things get nuts.
It's gonna be so gnarly. Followed up by the awards and then the best trick jam. And just if the Hastings contest in Vancouver was any indication, the best trick contest has been where some of the gnarliest highlights come from.
Here's a list of your favorite skateboarders world. Check it out in Heat 1. Of course, all eyes will be on Ivan Federico to see if he can maintain what he's been doing. You go to Heat 2. Who are you looking at in Heat 2, Neil?
Yeah, Heat 2. Corey Juneau and Tom Schaar have made a huge impact as challengers on this entire tour. Tristan Rennie skated great yesterday in qualifying, but how about Sky Siljig? He actually absolutely dominated yesterday. The only skater in the 90s, but can he make that magic happen 2 days in a row? We're going to find out.
And I sure Malmo's, hope so. He's Malmo's 3 and 4. All Park Select Pros.
Malmo's local hero, Oski, is in heat number 2 as well. So Oski's going to be competing in his hometown skate park in Malmo, Sweden in 3 weeks. So really excited that we've got a skater from Malmo that's going to the World Championships.
Now, every day, every time these contests come around, we got to pick our favorites. Neil Hendricks, you start us off.
I think this is Chris Russell's contest. This park really works for his style of aggressive, fast skating. He's got one of the best tricks I've seen in all the practice sessions. Out of the deep end to frontside invert on the extension, one of the gnarliest tricks, and Chris has been making that every time in practice. Also, close to home, he stays out of trouble. We saw Chris Russell,
he was
raging down in Australia and Brazil, and it worked out for him in Australia. But if he got a good night of sleep last night, watch out.
Well, my pick is Oscar Rosenberg Hallberg. One of the best styles in the business. He's been going hard on the road, putting in time in the van between events. He's been running with a really good crowd, and he's yet to really bust out, break through, and I think he's finally realizing that he has a purpose, and that is to be here, and that is to win this event. Plus, I want to be liked when I get to Sweden next month. So, Oscar Rosenberg, Hallberg, that's my pick. Let's go back down to the deck. Chris Pastris, who you got in Huntington Beach?
What's up, buddies? My pick is kind of an underdog here. My who to watch is Sky Siljig. He had magical runs in qualifying, and if Sky could dig into that deep cauldron again, he'll be in the 90s. He's also a crowd favorite, got everyone hyped, including his fellow pros. And let's face it, he's got the most creative lines and tricks of anyone out. Go, Sky!
Nice. A great pick. And that is going to be a fun skater to watch for sure. Let's get to the skate park. Of course, this park is custom and purpose-built every year on the beach here, right next to the pier as part of the Vans U.S. Open of Surfing. Similar layout to last year. It shifted around about 90 degrees. Neil, if you ask me, this is probably the most well-rounded park of the series so far.
Yeah, super excited to see this, and Ben Hatchell's going to show us around.
That could come in handy here. Some of the other places we visited, that wouldn't help you much.
What's up, guys? I'm Ben Hatchell. We're out here at the U.S. Open to Surf and the Huntington Beach Stop. Just wanted to tell you guys a little bit about this year's park. Deep ends changed up a little bit this year. They made it a bit more mellow, and all in all, the park's going off right now. It's been hectic all day. People are getting it in. There's a few changes. They made the nipple this year a little bit steeper, gave it a lip. That's the hip everybody goes blast off on. That's probably my favorite wall in the whole park. It's just that perfect training to boost on. It's probably not quite vert, but maybe the smoothest tranny in the park. I'm right behind you. Oh no, yes I am. So the spine's sick. They changed it up this year. Last year they had the shotgun barrel coping all the way into both sides, but this year they made it a bit mellower so you could just kind of like roll out and in. This is the perfect park for the series. Yeah, it's a little bit of everything and everybody can skate it differently and rip it in their own way. You good? Watch out! Yeah, it's all good. It's all good. It's part of the carnage. That was mellow compared to the shit that went down yesterday. People are going out on stretchers. That fucking hurt.
So Tim, less than 2 minutes right now. Right.
Wow.
Now.
So Ben Hatchell, you know, looked touch and go there for a minute. He's gonna potentially skate today.
Yeah, he's gonna try and give it a go. He has a separated shoulder from that slam that we saw with him giving the park preview, but he is out there practicing. Looks like Ben is gonna attempt to skate. Here's the format for today.
All right, four runs each, 45 second runs. You skate until you fall. You get a first wall rebate, one time only. The clock will reset for that first wall rebate. The best run counts.
That's very important. That's different from yesterday where it was overall impression.
Semifinals, 20 skaters, four heats, top nine qualifiers from yesterday. We'll meet the 11 PS Select pros from today. So there you have it. Top eight from this semifinals will be competing just in about an hour here. And as we know by now, Neil, these contests have a way of just firing off and going. What are the judges looking for? We have the best in the business down on the deck.
Yeah, judges are looking for difficulty of tricks, style, speed, consistency, use of park. They're using a 0 to 100 judging scale. Best run counts. We've got Kyle Berard, Jason Rothmeyer, Mike Sinclair. Those guys are ripping skaters in their own right and did a really good job judging the meat grinder qualifying day
yesterday.
They had
a hard job. It's not the sexiest part of the criteria, but use of park comes in huge. Here we go, semifinals. Heat number one, Ivan Federico from Turin, Italy. Josh Borden from right down the road, Orange County, California. Zion Wright from Jupiter, Florida. Mario Perez, a heavy hitter from Sao Paulo, Brazil, by way of Florianopolis. And Colin Graham, absolutely on fire yesterday from Virginia Beach. Neil Hendricks, expert opinion. What are we looking for in this heat?
You know, any one of these guys could be in the top eight finals. There are no weak heats here in the semis. Super excited that Zion made it in. It's his first Vans Park Series ever. But Ivan Federico, our first skater in, he won the last stop. He's got to earn his way into the top eight.
17 years old from Turin, Italy. Here we go. We're kicking off semifinal number one.
He has the kickflip melon on lock every try. Blunt to 50-50, pops out. Looked like the front truck just didn't lock in on the 50-50.
And maybe he was listening to that inner part of him saying he needs to mix up his runs, and it didn't go his way right there. So that was your first run, an uncharacteristic fall for our skater from Turin, Italy.
I like that he's mixing it up, though.
I like it, too.
You know, he's done that blunt slide every time. Got to get a little bit different now that it's semifinals.
Here's our look at the Axeman, Josh Borden. First run in the semifinals.
I'm so stoked that Josh made it here to the semis. He skated really good at our first stop in Melbourne, then didn't make it through to the semis in both Florianopolis and Vancouver. Oh, tough slam on the alley-oop over the hip.
Harsh slam to start us off for Josh Borden. Maybe just a case of nerves. I would say yesterday was the best we've seen him skate yet on this entire series.
These guys ride such loose trucks. Sometimes you just get a little wheel bite at the bottom of the tight tranny like that.
Brand new skater to the Park Series. We wish he had been on the whole Global Series. He's been ripping. Zion Wright, 17 years old, Jupiter Beach, Florida.
So cool yesterday. He snapped his board in half on a frontside air disaster on his second run. Kept skating on a broken board and skated well enough to make it through to the semifinals. Now he's gonna try and keep his board in one piece. Zion has been putting out some amazing street parts the last year or so. He's been around for a long time, but just in the last year, he got on Nike, he got on Red Bull, he's on the real team now. Zion is on the come up for sure.
Crazy, I thought of him as a street dog. Seen him in street parks, but he is tearing this Huntington Beach course apart.
Hey, you know, he lives in South Florida right by Alex Sorgente, so when you're homies with Alex Sorgente, you're gonna learn how to skate some tranny.
Yeah, you will be meeting at the skate park, no doubt. So Zion Wright, the best opening run yet on the day. And there he gets his skateboard back, and probably one of the coolest stories from yesterday. Second two runs done on a busted stick. Mario Perez waiting for scores to drop for Zion Wright. Pretty good, 72.90.
Good start, first big score of the day up in the 70s for Zion.
Can't mention Mario Perez without mentioning his huge, huge battle down here a couple years ago in the Van Dorn Invitational. Here goes Mario.
Yeah, he's been on the podium here in Huntington Beach back when it was Van Dorn Invitational, one of the fastest skaters in this park. Look how far he travels on that stalefish.
So smooth and so stylish that sometimes you forget how fast he's really going in this park.
He's another guy that I was so psyched that he made it through to the semis because he just wasn't quite able to put it together on the qualifying day at both Melbourne, Florianopolis, and Vancouver. Look at that Smith grind into the deep end front feeble. This is an insane first run. Frontside 5-0 revert.
So far, he has gone the deepest into his run. He's got 8 seconds left. What's he going to close with?
Yeah, and these runs are a little bit longer than yesterday, so the guys that skated the qualifying round aren't going to be able to do their same runs. They got 15 more seconds to fill. That was an amazing first run for Murillo Perez.
There's your Thrasher Magazine firing line. Right off the get-go, Murillo Perez with a solid 45-second fully flared run, and it's a huge score, 85.44.
That is huge. Murillo Perez might be joining us in the finals.
Wow, so a shot across the bow from
and
Perez.
Murillo could be a wild card to sneak in for one of those challenger spots for Malmo.
Colin Graham, a huge showing yesterday. He's hoping to keep the momentum flowing.
Yeah, Colin's another guy that's made it to a couple of our Vans Park Series stops earlier this year.
Triple like tweaked?
Tweaked it three different ways on the frontside nosebone. Was so stoked to see Colin make it through yesterday, representing for the new generation of Virginia Beach Rippers.
He's had some close calls in previous events as well, almost making the cut.
Yep. Yeah, Colin has just been ripping all over the world this year, skates a lot of the pool contests. Like, the Vans pool party, Bondi Ballerama. Look at that air rock slap pogo fakie, half cab rock fakie, cab disaster revert. Jeez. Now heat one is heating up.
A blistering combination in the deep. I didn't even see Murillo go into the deep end, so the judges now have to chomp on that. Last second combo, 1-2-3 punch from Colin Graham.
That was a huge trick at the end. I'm dying to see where the judges put this one.
So is Colin. An 80.01, so what are the differences between scores there?
Yeah, I think maybe just maybe Murillo's speed lines. Wow, Yvonne, another uncharacteristic fall. Our defending champ from Vancouver not putting it together here. Maybe he relishes the underdog role. Maybe it's hard for him to be the favorite.
Exactly. Here goes Josh Borden. Again, he's cut his teeth down at the Orange Skate Park, the Vans Park down there, and he's looking... almost, I was going to say looking a little bit more comfortable, but I...
Yeah, both Yvonne and Josh with a couple of early falls. If you just replayed their runs from qualifying yesterday, they both had four insane runs to make it through to the semifinals.
Dion Wright blasted through this park on his first run. Got a sizable score. We'll see if he can up his... antics in this line.
Yeah, hopefully we can get Zion out at some more of these Vans Park Series stops in 2017. Backside alley-oop, just shooting out on that tight landing.
A little bit under-rotated right there.
Yeah, just not able to absorb the low landing.
Sometimes when you come out to such a heavy start, it takes a minute. You settle back down, and now these guys are settling in. So like we said, they get four opportunities. The best one run will count. Murillo Perez, he's about to fly through this place.
Yeah, like you said, the judges were really feeling Murillo's first run. Back Smith to back tail. He took a monster slam on that trick yesterday. Great to see him pull it in his second run here in the semis.
Judges want to see if you go to Smith grind, you better dip that Smith.
Yeah, no kidding.
There. Now we see Murillo in the deep end.
Yeah, he's in the deep end. That's a good one. Crail slide and frontside grind and pop out. Back tail. He was going for back tail revert. That would have been huge.
So Murillo, he's out. Doesn't quite get to that 45-second mark, but kind of already sitting on a huge score for his first run. Here we go. Back in the park. It's Colin Graham.
Colin Graham has such a big bag of tricks. He saw he got an 80 on his first run. He's going to know what he's got to change and what he's got to add to bump that score up. Look at that. Looked like he was going for Stalefish to Smith stop. Didn't quite lock onto the coping good enough.
A little over psych right there.
That was huge, man. That was like a truck breaker. I think we talked about it yesterday. We saw three guys snap their boards in half.
Yvonne Federico, he's got to recuperate from two early falls. We'll
yeah,
see if he
did you
can
see
put it
he
together.
Didn't flip his board right there. He's got a case of the nerves. He always does that kickflip melon. That time he just did a judo air. He's trying to get his contest legs under him right now. Again.
This is looking bad.
Yeah,
Yvonne right
never,
now.
But there again, it's not overall impression. He just needs one run. You see that frustration.
Josh Borden. So far, okay. We want to see him get into that excellent range.
Thought he was going to try and pop into the switch crooks right there on the 5-0 to tail slide. There's the alley-oop backside air and a frontside 360 planting the hand over the spine.
Crowd loves that one.
That is so cool. That is hard on a really small spine like that. Dipping that back Smith through the deep end corner.
20 seconds.
Trying to get that speed back. These runs are longer than yesterday. He would have been popping out.
12 more seconds to go. Now he's in the deep end. This is where he really shines.
He was trying his hardest to hold onto that flip slide. He was completely shooting out, but did not want to jump off.
Big ups to Josh Borden, the big cat. Definitely has one of the best skateboard graphics out right now, bloody axe. And there you see his third run. Yeah, he improved to 68.56. So again, he's got one more chance. And back in the park, it is Mr. Zion Wright.
Wow, look at that 540 again with a low landing. Just wasn't able to hold on to it. That was pretty cool, just jumping onto his board down the waterfall.
Yeah, some of the mess around tricks these dudes do are psychotic.
These guys are just natural. What they do instinctually on a skateboard is not human.
All right, Mario Perez needs business. Third run here in semifinal number one.
Current leader right now.
God, that lip set looks so easy.
Yeah, and look at that. All in, out of the Smith grind, into the deep end. Murillo tried that back tail revert transfer his last run. Is he going to go for that one again? That would be a huge trick.
That's where we saw all the broken boards on those two walls in that back corner.
Wow, back lip up onto the bank. He's got 15 seconds to go on his third run. Oh, the heel flip frontside air was right there, and he couldn't grasp it.
What happened? Just missed the grab on the flip?
Yeah, you know, something like that, it just has to flip into your hand perfect to put it on your feet.
All right, we are back up to the top. We got Colin Graham. Never discount this skater from Virginia. Here we go. Always comes in hot. He is going to be flying.
Love that Colin is starting out his runs different every time, but the lean varial got away from him.
Harsh. Third run, he's got one more opportunity. Here we go, last look, the last chance for a guy who had gotta be your favorite. False start, all right. Hold on, everyone's getting a little fired up. So Ivan Federico has not put together a run like we've seen him be capable of. A very, again, uncharacteristic
fall. This is huge right now. This is Yvonne's last chance. If he doesn't get a good result here, it could bump him out of qualifying for the Malmo World Championships. Oh my gosh, that is so uncharacteristic.
I'm shocked.
Yvonne, ever since I've ever seen him coming up as a young amateur, he's always been so good at skating contests. I've never seen him blow it like that before.
I mean, a literal hush just fell over the crowd. People were wondering, what is up?
Hey, that's the pressure of winning the last contest. You're now the favorite.
And skating in front of the biggest crowd of the whole series. Josh Borden now, trying to put it together.
Would love to see Josh put one down. He's from right down the street, so he's got a lot of friends and family in the big crowd here.
He's building momentum through this run.
He's got really good deep end tricks. Didn't go for the backsmith that run. Cool little transfer out of the deep end.
18 seconds to go.
Love that little whip over the spine. Going frontside to backside 5-0.
We're gonna get an invert in here.
There's the Smith grind through the corner. Looks like Josh is going to stay on for 45.
Almost pushed.
He thought about pushing, and then he's like, I'm in a park contest. Hey, you know, Josh is a really good street skater, though. He made the semis at Tampa Pro Street this year.
Hell yeah. Well, all the way to the end, Josh Borden puts together his best complete run. Tell us about the judges we have on hand today.
Yeah, we got some good ones. Looks like Josh is still going to be in fourth place. Kyle Berard is one of the best skaters in the world in terrain like this, now building parks. So him and Jason Rothmeyer and Mike Sinclair do a great job for the border.
I saw at Roth Digga shredding the curbs the other day. Yep. Check that out, Instagram out. You see our judges rip too. This is Zion Wright. Last run in semifinal number one for Zion.
Zion's got to make these huge blasts. Look at that, the confidence for the huge tail smack. Madonna took straight to his knee. That's such a bummer.
The fact that these dudes are slamming this hard this early in the semifinals tells me how hot it's going to get here in the park. This is madness.
Really wanted to see Zion make it a little bit further in that run. I wanted to see that 540 over the hip.
Last looks for Murillo Perez.
Is he going to go for the back tail revert?
Please.
Back Smith to back tail.
Love his style. He's compact.
I'm so stoked that Murillo's made that twice in a row. I saw him really struggling with that in practice. Look at that. Huge lofty stalefish with confidence. Oh, the lip slide didn't lock in.
He's just as confused as we are, because we've seen him do that every single time. We've got one skater left. This has to be a massive run.
Yeah, Colin needs a huge one. He's in second place with an 80, but we got three more heats after this.
And we're only taking
Is he eight. Gonna go for the lean varial? Nope, staying on the lip with a dip Smith grind. That is such a rad tweaked frontside.
That looks
wow.
so fun.
He fully hung on that tail grab over the hip. These guys are so gnarly that they're so committed that even when their wheels clip and they hang up, they just power through. Wow, heel flip Indy on the extension. He knew that he had to add some difficulty to get up there where Murillo's score was.
Well, if you fall, your run is done. And just like that, semifinal number one is in the books. An incredible lineup of most likely some of your favorite skateboarders in the world will be coming up in the next heat. Watch out for our number one qualifier from yesterday, Sky Siljig. And here are your Heat 1 results. How did we get to these scores, Neil?
Yeah, Murillo just threw the hammer down that first run. Super fast, you know, all the airs he did, he carved super far. The backsmith to tail slide transfer. Great skating by Brazil's Murillo Perez.
And Noah, what do you think he did differently to kind of get the judges' attention?
I think it was the speed, you know, the distance that he traveled and just really good style.
All right, well, here we go. We're going to go into Heat 2 after this quick break. Stick around, more action to come. This is the Vans Pro Skate Park Series.
All right, right here, Crispy. This is the one.
Welcome back to the Vans Pro Skate Park Series live from Huntington Beach. I've got to thank Bonsai Bowls keeping all of the skateboarders and commentators laced up. Look at this thing.
It's so
ice
cool that they actually pay us in Bonsai Bowls.
We're rolling.
That's
Cheers.
Amazing. Cheers.
Oh yeah, Chris Cote here with Neil Hendricks. So far, semifinal one, a little bit of everything. We saw slams, we saw glory, high speed skating. And a couple of near misses, yeah. But Murillo Perez has set the tone.
But I feel like the huge story is the guy that won the last Park Series stop in Vancouver is not going to advance to the finals today, and he's going to be on the bubble to even qualify for our World Championships in Malmo next month.
Yeah, Ivan Federico, we had just incredibly high hopes, especially the way he skated yesterday through that meat grinder qualifier. Now he's got to sit on the sidelines and watch this whole thing unfold. He can't do anything about it.
Yeah, Florianopoulos, he got second, barely bumped out by Pedro. Vancouver, he dominated. He won by a few points. Could not put it together, and I think that's just, he was the underdog. No one really expected him to be a contender in Florianopoulos or Vancouver. He got second and first. Now at this event, we expected him to, you know, be in the finals and expected him to podium. Cracked under pressure.
With pressure. There you go. Well, on the deck right now, speaking of pressure, this guy is now out of the pressure cooker. Murillo Perez absolutely ripped that first semi. He is with Chris Pastris.
Murillo, so you were with us in Vancouver, you were with us in Floripa, did make the cut at either of those events. What is different here today?
I think it's I'm more motivated. Like, my family has always helped me, support me, like, even if I fall, if I win. But some of my friends couldn't be here today, and I said to them that I was going to skate for them. And I think I'm happy. They for sure are happy. Pedro, Foguinho, this one was for you. I hope to see you guys soon in Copenhagen, but I'm gonna do everything that I need to do here for you guys and my family for sure.
Yeah, man, that was awesome. Murillo Perez, Heat number one winner. Congrats, buddy. Back to you guys up top.
Thank you, Pastris. So again, the high speed attack from Murillo Perez. I love the passion there, giving it up for his friends and family right off the get-go. Let's take a look at the Heat recap from our first semifinal. This was a burner to start us off.
Yeah, Yvonne made that kickflip melon in his first run, and that was about the last thing he made, was not able to put it together, unfortunately. Look at that, Colin Graham, huge mute rock to fakie, killing it in the deep end. Cab disaster back revert, but check out the high-speed attack of Murillo Perez. Yeah, Yvonne taking it into the deep end, but that was a huge shocker. I was talking to Yvonne. He bruised his heel really bad the first day of practice here. Not sure if that bruised heel ended up affecting his skating here in the semis.
Well, it's always tough. And remember, he was the first skater to drop in, too. So to add the pressure on top of the pressure.
It is never easy to be the first skater, especially in a heated lineup like this.
Well, check it out. So we're not just giving trophies and to the winners here today at Vance Park Series Huntington Beach. You can also win at home. This is Neil Hendricks' new Kyle Walker Pro shoe, but we've got extra. You can actually win one at home.
Yeah, so hashtag Vance Park Series. We love scrolling through the hashtag to see where you guys are watching from. Show us where you're watching, but
get
just
creative,
beware.
Right?
Whoever wins, we're going to show you on screen.
Yeah,
so don't do anything shady.
Yeah, don't get too weird, because the world will see you. So there you have it. Hashtag Vance Park Series at Vance Park Series. Get weird. Have fun. You could win a pair of some of the best skate shoes I've ever ridden. And from there, let's go with Tom Schaar, one of the threats to take this whole thing out. It's been absolutely ripping.
Tom Schaar here at the US Open. Practice is going down right now. Everyone's getting ready for the contest. It's going to be sick. I think it's because park skating is like the most fun to watch in a contest. Everyone seems crazy. It's like, you know, some transfers that could go down and like things that haven't been done yet. So I don't know. I think it's like the most exciting thing for sure. Yeah, you have to be really creative to skate parks like this, because otherwise everyone's just gonna be doing the same line, and you know, it's kind of boring to watch. So everyone tries to like mix it up and add their own kind of style to it. Yeah, the way the like overall scoring system works is you just get like a certain amount of points, like depending on what place you get at each stop. And add up, and I think it's top seven guys, whoever has the most points, go to Malmö, Sweden, join the other select pros and everyone. So it's cool. I like the system. It's like you got like a goal to like work towards. It's not like just one event, so it's for sure different.
Tom Schaar, a definite crowd favorite, 16 years old. He runs with a ripping crowd, and he is all over the world. I mean, every time I tune into a webcast, I see Tom Schaar flying around a park or a bowl. Here we go. Semifinals, Heat 2, Corey Juneau from San Diego, Tom Schaar from Malibu, Tristan Rennie from Rialto, California, Sky Siljig, our number one qualifier from yesterday, and Oscar Rosenberg Halberg, one of our Vans Park Series select pros from Malmö, Sweden. Again, anyone's ballgame, such an eclectic mix of skaters. And,
yeah, really,
this is a little warm-up right
really
here.
Curious to see if Sky Siljig can make the magic happen 2 days in a row. Yesterday, it was like it was unlike anything I've ever seen. He was so on fire. He did a handful of tricks he hadn't even thought about trying. Absolutely had no plan when he dropped into his runs, and everything just worked out perfect. I looked down and just saw all of his buddies, all the pros on the deck. Their jaw was just on the floor with how Sky was skating.
To start us off with semifinal number two with 45 seconds on the clock, it is Corey Juneau.
Corey Juneau has been on fire this whole year in the Vans Park Series. Really confident now when it comes to this type of skateboarding. Heel flip Indy looked like he was just a little bit too far over the deck. Didn't want to risk the monster slam right there. Had to bail out.
Well, it's not bad to get that first bail run out of the way on your first run, because you got three more shots. And we just saw a little piece on this kid, Tom Schaar, absolute ripper, one of the highest flying skaters in this entire series. Here we go, Tom Schaar.
Tom really wants to qualify for Malmö, so he needs a good result here. He's been going to all the stops around the world, trying to make it look like he yanked too hard on that alley-oop backside air over the channel.
I have to say, of course, we know how gnarly Tom Schaar is on vert, but he is the most improved park skater of the entire season
100%.
By far. Tristan Rennie from Rialto, California. This dude has some tech abilities, and he is going to showcase those for us for 45 seconds. Here we go.
Yeah, Tristan has been absolutely killing the last couple stops. His trucks are so loose, he's able to get these tricky lines and combinations that no one else can do. Look at that little nose pick out of the deep end. That is so tricky, that spot.
Tristan Rennie, he's got a ton of tricks, but what's he got to do to stand out in this heavy crowd?
Just more of what he's doing, man. He ended up, I believe, second in the qualifying round yesterday. So look at that 540 over the hip.
Perfect.
This run is huge. only 7 more seconds to go for
Stay
a perfect
on.
First run. Feet are flying off on that ollie. Looks like he's going to pull it off. This is going to be last trick right here. Little Indy Boner in the deep end. Front feeble, and that is a perfect first run for Tristan Rennie.
And I loved how after he made that perfect 540, he just not kept it mellow, but he just did tricks that he knew he could ride away from, finishing the perfect run. He is psyched. Crowd's going nuts. And I think the judges' fingers are flying, give him a huge score.
How is that going to compare to Murillo Perez from the first heat? I think that's going to be really close. Slots into second place. That's still a really good score.
You know, I think the difference there, it was the speed factor for Murillo.
I agree with you.
All right. A lot of people's new favorite skateboarder. Probably the most creative guy on the board today.
This
talking
guy
about Sky Siljan.
Is so fun to watch, man. Oh, my gosh. He almost slid out. I'm so glad he stayed on.
Yes.
Sweeper over the teardrop. Oh my gosh, he did an invert disaster and jumps to the flat. I don't think he was planning on going to disaster. That is a good way to break your fingers.
He almost made his fingers into jelly.
That is insane. I thought he was gonna slide out on that first backsmith. Don't even know how he held on.
Not a lot of skaters kind of elicit that reaction when they drop in of just pure excitement, and you never know what he's gonna do. Here goes your pro select from Malmo, Sweden, Oski.
This is another guy that's a lot of people's new favorite skater. He just dropped a new Instagram clip for Nike SB a couple days ago. We were all watching from the Nike warehouse up in Portland. But he is he's one of the rippers from Malmo, Sweden, where we're going in 3 weeks.
And one of the reasons why I picked Oscar was just due to the fact that he's running with Grant Taylor and the crew. And you can tell he's just got that much more confidence, even from last event.
Look at this run. He did a back nose blunt on that big bank and looked like he almost hung up. Wow, love the nose grab on the roll in. Layback, roll out, backside.
Couple more seconds.
Backside 360 in the deep end. That was huge. Half cab rock fakey. Jumps off the Caballero, but I believe that was after time. That was a great start for Oski.
Thank you, Oscar, for making me look smart.
Yeah.
For picking you at the beginning of this event. A hell of a run for Oscar Rosenberg Hallberg. That's a fun name to say.
I like it. That's fun skateboarding to watch. Got your boy Ronnie Sandoval handing you waters on the deck. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's pretty rad also to see this kind of family, the Park Series family come together. A lot of new friends being made on the park, and that's a good vibe, and there you have it. Second place, 84.15 for Oscar Rosenberg Hallberg. What was the difference there? What did he do to jump up into the leading
that
like that?
That whole run was awesome, but I love that back nose blunt on the steep bank.
Here we go. Corey Juno, his first run was a no-go. What's he got here, Neil?
Yeah, starting it out with a speedy backsmith. We'll see if he makes it down into the deep end to try that heel flip Indy again. This is where he bailed first run again. Didn't see him miss that a single try yesterday in qualifying, but that deep end is really tricky. It's 9'3" deep, but it doesn't even really go to vert. The whole thing is just kind of a steep bank. And these guys were mentioning to me that they were really struggling with airs and flip tricks in that deep end.
Here we go, our second look at Tom Shark, and one of the highest flyers. He is a vert ripper, and he's taking those skills into the park with ease.
Yeah, this dude skates mega ramps, he skates parks, he skates vert, but he's really been focusing on park terrain skating recently. Stoked that he ended up making all these stops at the Vans Park Series. Hopefully we're gonna see him in Malmo as well.
He's got a really clean style too, and there's his bread and butter.
Yeah, in the tricky deep end. That is not like Tom Shar's normal vert ramp. That is a really hard deep end to spin a 540 in.
You'd have to say he's got the most automatic 540 of anyone.
That's a huge fall though. Still was a couple seconds on the clock for that front blunt. The difference between making and bailing that trick is gonna be a few points.
Well, that's the last thing the judges see as well. You know, of course they see the whole thing and they judge the whole run, but you wanna leave them with stoke, you know, you want to pop out right onto the deck. It's just like,
out,
I got this.
Yeah, popped out with the victory wave after that front blunt would be a lot better than, climbing out of the bowl.
So Tom Shar, his second run, obviously it's about three times better than his first run, a 79.64. That's enough for fifth place. Remember, taking the top eight. Here we go, yeah. Tristan Rennie.
Think you're gonna need to be in the 80s for sure to end up in the top eight. Tristan Rennie had a great start. What can he add to a second run? Looks like he's switching his lineup a little bit. Love that alley-oop front 50-50.
Neil, with best run of four, are they allowed to kind of do the same run over and over?
Did you see that?
That was the add-on, wasn't it?
Yeah, that stand-up front nose grind. Yeah, you really, in a format like this, where it's only best run counts, you can really do the same line and just add harder and harder tricks to it. You're not going to get scored down for doing the same run over and over in a format like this.
Now here's a guy, we have no idea what's about to happen whenever he drops in, and that's what makes him so entertaining. Sky Siljak from Seattle, Washington.
Wow, back Smith to board slide, then blunt slide grabbing the nose. This is the Sky Siljak we saw yesterday.
Wow, he does tricks with no names. I love it.
You know, I always say that Sky never has a plan, but those first two tricks were one of the runs that he started with yesterday. Curious to see if the judges count that as a fall. He kind of just washed out onto the deck. That's Sky just having fun.
With a rollout, a barrel roll.
Gosh, the beginning of that run was so cool. Backsmith to board slide transfer. That is so hard.
Now, do those tricks, do those resonate with the judges? Are those tricks that could win you this contest?
I feel like if he put 45 seconds together, he could totally win this contest. But first, he's got to get in the top eight.
Here we have a look at Oscar Rosenberg, Hallberg, Advanced Pro Select from Malmo, Sweden.
I love how Oski always looks surprised when they call his name for his run. He's always just over there chilling like, me? I have to go next? Wow.
Make Cavalera. Make it.
That was one of the coolest contest makes ever. Little pop shove on the bank.
Keep going. You got 20 seconds.
This run is a total bust, but he's just having fun right now.
That bust run would be my best run ever.
Totally.
Just finishing off a quick kickflip.
I can't wait to see the slow-mo replay of that Caballero totally in the back seat. Just heels dragging off the board.
Do you see the difference in confidence from Oski now? The first two events, he was just kind of like, am I worthy? Am I supposed to be here? I feel like he knows that he's at this level, that he deserves to be here.
Still sitting in second, just barely behind Murillo Perez with that 84.15. Still a really good score.
And there you have your top eight thus far here in the semifinals, Murillo Perez with that 85.44. Got a feeling that he's fairly safe with that mid 80. But here we go, Corey Juno, he's gonna try to make Murillo feel a little bit more unsafe, hopefully with a complete run.
Yeah, this has been one of the most consistent skaters of the whole Vans Park series. Had a couple falls on that heel flip indie in the deep end. Curious to see if he keeps that trick in this run or maybe switches it out for something different.
Corey Juno, usually one of the more consistent skaters in this series.
He still went for it and washed out again. Three times for the heel flip indy. Three times he slammed on it.
You know, I liked, though, that he kind of filled the beginning of his run with a couple tricks that he has fully got. And like you said, usually that's his go-to trick.
But that was not filler tricks. He did a stand-up nose grind transfer, a front blunt on the 8-foot wall. That was still really hard tricks.
Tom Schaar now with 45 seconds on the clock.
Tom Schaar is currently in fifth place. Needs a good run. He wants to qualify for Malmo. Last time we checked the challenger standings, he was in fifth, right on the bubble of qualifying. He could get bumped out by some of the other challengers that are going for that spot also.
That massive backside ollie is just so fun to watch.
Love
every
that.
Time.
Grabbing backside on that one. Has that five
no problem.
Every time in the deep end, but the Smith grind did not lock in.
Tell me about that transition, landing the 540, going into Smith like that so quick.
Yeah, it is super tricky, and you know, a Smith grind like that, Tom could probably do every try, but like you said, you're landing a 540, so you might not be aimed for the corner exactly right. You have to make last second adjustments. That's what makes it hard.
looking at Tristan Rennie, his third run here in semifinal two. We've seen more complete runs in this semi.
Yeah, Tristan doing it for the Badlands out in the Inland Empire area of Southern California. Rialto is where he calls home. Yeah, I love that stand-up nose grind that Tristan did in his last run around that deep end corner. There we have it again. He just balances on the nose. It's almost like a G-turn when you're riding on flat ground. Wasn't able to pull it off that time.
Is that an added piece of art for those people watching who didn't see that yesterday?
Yeah, Tyler Muma.
All right, Sky Siljay. We're hoping to see 45 seconds of pure, unadulterated madness on a skateboard.
Wow, did you see that board slide? Boneless through the corner. This is the Sky Siljay that we wanted to see. Little pop over the camera cords, trying to nose bonk on the hip. Just getting weird. This is the Sky Siljay that we love. But when you have no plan, sometimes you run into the channel for no reason.
He has so much control for being so out of control.
Dude, did you see that board slide? I didn't see him try that a single time in practice. Board slide from the shallow all the way through the deep end corner.
Yeah, this guy right there just realizing he's got one more shot.
I like Daniel Vargas stretching out his buddy, Ronnie Sandoval.
Trainer, Oscar Rosenberg, Hallberg. Full 42 seconds on the clock. He is in second place right now.
Yeah, it looked like last
speed
run,
wobbles.
Oski kind of lost his rhythm, couldn't get it back. This run's looking a lot more solid. Wow, 5-0 back revert, getting completely twisted on reentry.
Oh,
if that was
harsh.
Your or my knee, I think our leg would have popped off.
You'd be calling an ambulance at this moment.
Dude, my knee does not bend like that.
I'm hurt just seeing that.
That is insane. I thought we were stopping the contest to like medevac someone out of the park.
He's totally fine. All right, Corey Juno, last chance for one of our highest ranking qualifiers thus far on this series.
Yeah, the same trick has bit Corey Juno three runs in a row. Here he goes, back into the deep end for the heel flip Indy. Still was gonna hang up that time. Four runs, four heel flip Indy bails for Corey Juno. That hurts.
You know, it's a keeper result, just qualifying, of course, for the semis. But if you want to be a lock to go to Malmo, you really got to get into the final series. And that's what Tom Schaar is hoping for right now in his fourth and final run of semi number two.
Tom's another guy, had a couple falls right at the end of his runs, hasn't put the full 45 seconds down yet. See Tom still working on that same line, that huge boosty backside ollie, doing the same line over and over again. Isn't gonna hurt you too much on the score sheets in this format. See if he spins a 540. Looked like he missed his speed, he missed his pump into the deep end, wasn't able to do the 540. Back D revert, front blunt right here. Nope, going for something different. Boneless through the corner. Good ending right here. Looks like Tom might have got a little bit lost. He did a 540 out of a backside disaster.
Now explain the difficulty within that combination.
Yeah, he normally was doing the 540 after he did a frontside air transfer into the deep end. He had a low landing and missed his setup, so he had to kind of abort it and do some other tricks. Still snuck the 540 in there, but after a backside disaster, that is not how you set up for a big 540.
That's just not right, and
yeah.
It made it work.
He muscled it around.
Well, Tom Schaar needs an 85.45 or better for first place. Judges are deliberating. They give him an 81.99. That's enough for fourth.
Yeah, you
know. So he's safe for now.
You could tell he was a little bit lost and kind of stuck in that deep end. I feel like he wasn't smooth enough to bump up into the 84 or 85s.
Last chance right now for Tristan Rennie, who's sitting in third place.
Yeah, Tristan's still looking good from that solid first run, but we've seen just with a couple tricks that he's added on the runs that he fell on, he's got a little bit more, I think. That stand-up nose grind is one of my favorite tricks of this entire contest that anyone does.
Just flowing around the park, makes it look so nice and smooth.
He's able to just turn on a dime. There's another fall in the deep end. Guys are really struggling with airs down there.
You know, I'm kind of seeing in the middle portion with, Tom, Tristan, even Corey. Everyone's kind of blending in, you know, they're not really busting out the crazy tricks. Sky Seljig, can he put it together? 45 seconds on the clock.
Currently in ninth place, so not in an advancing position right now. We would love to see Sky Seljig in the finals later today. Doing a completely different run again. Look at that boneless into the deep end corner. This run is looking good, and it goes wrong on the spine.
He splits the cheeks right there. Board goes one way, he goes the other way. If you fall, you're done. So that was it for Sky Siljag. A hell of a run, and we are stoked to have seen him skate here in Huntington Beach. Our final skater of semifinal heat number two, Oscar Rosenberg Halberg. We call him Oski for short. It looks like he's starting the unique boneless in the park.
Gosh.
Yeah, nobody's used that first wall rebate yet.
Yeah, Oski is currently in second place, so he's has the potential of advancing into the top eight for later. Can he add a little bit more? I love, he's another guy that every one of his runs has been completely different. Perfect nose grind on the extension. Ollieing up to a Smith grind. Looked like he was gonna come up a little bit short. Had to will it around.
Got 14 seconds. Just that little kind of like ollie pump in the deep end looked so rad.
But another air bail in the deep end. Guys are really struggling just with that 9 foot deep end being a little bit undervert.
Now we shall see who we take to the finals, potentially out of heat number two. All of our skaters had four opportunities. And we've got a heavy hitting list of skaters in heat three and heat four. We're talking Grayson Fletcher, Curran Caples as you ski. Jaws is here, Chris Russell. The list of skaters coming up in these next two heats is nothing short of spectacular. Here we go, your semifinals. Current standings, Murillo Perez in first, Oscar Rosenberg Hallberg in second, Tristan Rennie in third, Tom Schaar hanging on in fourth.
Yeah, a couple of the guys that we thought would really be contenders for those final positions, Yvonne Federico and Sky Siljig, who qualified first yesterday, not going to advance to the top eight today.
Who are you worried about on this list right now?
Man, it's we're halfway through the semifinals. Right now it's looking like an 80 is going to get you in, but you look at the heavy hitters in that last heat. Our last couple of events, that last heat hasn't really put it together, so... Never know.
You never know. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back with semifinals heat three. This is the Vans Pro Skate Park Series, Huntington Beach. Welcome back to the best skate park ever on the beach here in Huntington Beach. This is the Vans Pro Skate Park Series. Chris Cote here with Neil Hendricks. Neil, so far, sonar.
Yeah, halfway through our semifinals, but hashtag where you're watching from, hashtag Vans Park Series. We love scrolling through the photos, see where everyone's watching from, and we're gonna give away some shoes.
Give us an example. What would you do if you were home watching? How would you win those shoes?
I would be
doing an
air. I don't know. I think good, cool barbecue in the backyard by the pool with a bunch of chicks in bikinis.
Perfect.
I've never done that, but it like sounds cool.
Right on. Well, Oscar Rosenberg Hallberg ripped in that last heat. He's on the deck with Chris Pastris.
Oski, I know you've been shredding with the Thrasher guys and traveling a bunch. Is that helping you here this weekend? Because you're killing it.
Yeah, I'm just so fired up to skate with all those dudes. It's so fun to be on trip with those guys.
How long were you on the road?
19 days, but I've been in the States for almost 5 weeks.
We got to send you on the road before more contests. And we're coming to you in Malmo, Sweden soon. How excited are you for that?
It looks sick. I've seen the park. My dad just sent me a clip of the park. It's just finished. It looks really good. It's like the first thing I'm going to do when I get back home, skate the park.
Right on. Yeah. Well, we'll see you in a couple weeks. Round of applause for Oski Rosenberg. Yeah, brother, you smashed it.
Yeah, Pastris. It's the first thing we're going to do when we get to Malmo as well. Well, we've just seen some thrashing going on. You got to say, heat number two definitely brought us some more consistency in the park. Here's a look back at how it all went down.
Tom Schar with that patented, tweaked out Stalefish on the extension. This is Tristan Rennie popping into the deep end. Super creative line to get down there. Nose grab, backside air disaster. He's got the 540, spin to win over the hip. Wow, Sky really should have slammed on that backsmith. Somehow he didn't, still did a sweeper over the teardrop. Oski almost clipped on that back nose blunt. Slashing over the spine and backside 360 into the corner on the deep end.
If you want to see more Sky Siljig like we know you do, just Google him and watch his videos. They're
look
awesome.
At this, Tristan Rennie fully on top. Backsmith to board slide, that is pretty much impossible. Oski's got the backside 360 every which way, and there's Cavalario with his feet dancing all over his skateboard. That board slide was insane from Sky Siljig.
What was your favorite trick in Semi 2?
Honestly, I think it was that Cavalario that Oski did, because he completely should have bailed, but it was a contest, so he just tried to do anything he could to hang on. His feet were all over the place.
The bail factor here is so low because these guys just, they want it so bad.
There again, Oski looking crazy.
All right, there you see your recap from semifinal number two, and we're about to get wild here. Live from Huntington Beach, Vans Pro Skate Park Series semifinal, heat number three. Absolutely stacked. Let's take a look at Grayson Fletcher.
I'm Grayson Fletcher. We're here at US Open Huntington Beach for the Vans Skate Tour. They have this bowl. They're trying to make a little bit like Marseille, some flashback vibes. Sick. Marseille contest used to go off. This contest goes off, so it's going to be a fun contest. It's going to be cool. Murillo Perez. We got V over here. Tom Schar showing up for Element, representing Element also. Trey Wood's gonna show up. We got Ronnie Sandoval. Robbie will probably show up. Whole San Pedro crew, Riley. I can't even name. There's so many names. I don't know. I don't make goals. That way you don't gotta try to pursue them. I don't know. At least you don't let yourself down. Try your best. Always try your best, no matter what. Don't be scared to slam into each other, boys. That's what I gotta add. Skate with your friends, drop in on them, tease them, crash into them. They'll love it.
Remind me never to go skating with Grayson.
I love it. I don't set goals.
One of the best dudes
Grayson,
ever.
Grayson, how about a goal? Like, let's not get arrested this weekend at US Open. How about that?
Grayson Fletcher. One of those guys that, I swear, so unpredictable. Right as he's starting to roll in, it's almost like your heart just goes in your throat because you have no idea what he's going to do.
Want to hear something insane? I saw Grayson playing Pokemon Go on his phone a couple days ago. Least likely dude to be playing Pokemon ever.
Here's your semifinal heat three. Grayson Fletcher, Kevin Kowalski, a perennial threat. Jack Vardell from Australia. Curran Caples, one of the smoothest ever to do it. And, of course, Aaron Homoki. You might be thinking, Aaron Homoki, who is that? Well, that's Jaws.
We need the Jaws theme. We're right by the beach. Super excited for this heat.
You're right.
Kevin Kowalski's been on the podium twice in the Vans Park Series this year. And our last stop in Vancouver made the insane transfer in Hastings in his run.
Had the win, basically.
Yeah, we had seen it happen in best trick contest before from Dalton Dern. But Kowalski did it in his contest run. We got Schmitty down there getting the clip for ThrasherMagazine.com.
Oh, cue the death metal. Here we go, Grayson Fletcher, first run here in semifinal number three.
This is so fun to watch. Super unpredictable, kind of like we were talking about with Sky Siljig last time. You never know what you're going to get from Grayson. Sometimes it's magic, sometimes it's crap.
So rare to see him fall on a front. That's one of his just automatic moves, that front blunt.
Yeah, it seems like there's a few people that have just had really early falls in their first run. Then they kind of work out the kinks, get their legs under them, pull it together.
Like you said, Kevin Kowalski, he's already got some hardware from the Vans Park Series, couple top three finishes from Portland, Oregon. Kevin Kowalski now in the park.
Every Park Series contest this year, he's done something really memorable. In Melbourne, he did the huge transfer that no one else did. In Florianopolis, he was the only one to foot plant off the railing. In Vancouver, he did that transfer in his run. What's he gonna do here in this Huntington Beach Park that no one else is doing?
You know, Kevin's, again, he's a really smart, competitive skater. So you see him building a line here. He's just kind of building towards something.
And you know what I've noticed also? He's another guy that doesn't bring his big guns out until his third or fourth run. Sometimes he gets like a solid, consistent run in the bag and pulls out the bangers at the end.
I feel like that's exactly what he's done here. A full 45-second run for Kevin Kowalski.
That was a super good run, man. That is how you start a semifinals.
Hey, it was subtle, but everything was done just perfectly.
Yeah, is that gonna be in the 80s?
Judges deliberate as we speak. Kevin Kowalski waiting for a score, a 71.62.
Wow.
The judges are not tricked. They're not fooled
by the... judges were not feeling that one. That score surprises me a little bit.
Maybe just a little, they're expecting a little bit more. Jack Fardell, another super smooth skater, 26 years old from Australia. Here we go.
Yeah, we've talked about it all year, but he put out one of the craziest video parts of the year in Adidas away days. Unfortunately, he had to miss the Park Series stop down in Melbourne when he was finishing up his part. But after that part came out, he's been to every stop since. Wow, did you see that nose grind transfer? No one else is doing that out of the deep end over the hip.
This is one of the best runs already that he's put together all series.
Yeah, 5-0 to Fakie. That was like 30 feet long on the metal coping.
10 more seconds, stay on your board.
Frontside 50-50 in the deep end. Really pumping for speed. Love that transfer. You heard his wheel slide. He was able to hang on.
Wow. He just lit this
nose
place
grind
up.
To Fakie. What a run for Jack Fardell.
Best run of his entire Vans Park Series.
Yeah, he had
thus
some
far.
Good ones in Florianopolis, but I'm backing you on that.
So Jack Fardell, so smooth, so stylish with speed, using the entire park. The judges have their hands full with that first run from Fardell. I like it, wasting no time getting into his hammers. A 78.63, he is in sixth place. What can he do to improve on that run?
Wow, a little bit surprised at that one also. He's still behind Tom Schaar and Colin Graham. Gonna have to try and add a couple more hard tricks to that run.
Well, the crowd.
Yeah, judges are being harsh today.
Crowd going as wild as we've heard them all day for Curran Caples.
Yeah, Curran, so styly. Got the smooth surf style, pumping around. Look at that boned out frontside poker. But Curran is not all looks, man. He has been ripping the practice sessions the last couple days.
You're not afraid of a good slam, is he?
Man, I still think about Curran breaking his arm at this contest, Van Doren Invitational. I believe it was last year or the year before. I thought he was a threat to win the contest. Ended up having to go to the hospital. Such a bummer.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jaws.
Jaws has been on tour with the Birdhouse Boys doing King of the Road and then filming for the Birdhouse video the last few months. So
winning King of the Road.
Yeah, they won King of the Road thanks to the Clint Walker antics. Love watching that on Viceland.
Yeah, sorry if you hadn't watched that yet. Yeah, they won.
Sorry.
Jaws, he put together an incredible in transition for the Barracks. Really surprised me in how good he is in parks.
Look at this. 540 going for the McTwist in the deep end. Unfortunate fall with about 12 or 13 seconds to go.
So You know, what do you think the strengths with Jaws? We saw what he did at Detour. Absolutely, he literally flying out of the park.
Yeah. It's
Hopefully, he's got something big for us in his next couple of runs.
Yeah, kind of like what we were saying with Kowalski. He looks at the course completely different. He's going to find something to do that no one else is even trying.
Cannot be contained. Here we go, Grayson Fletcher. His first run was a bit of a dud. We'll see if he can put it together here.
Yeah, Grayson is not the most consistent guy, but when he puts it together, it is so special. Even from Vancouver, he didn't advance to the finals in Vancouver, and he had all the highlight clips from the best trick contest.
So Grayson now, his second run. I'm pretty sure his third run's gonna be crazy. I'll have a good feeling about it. Kevin Kowalski. Right here, he's gonna have to ramp it up just a bit. Stay on his board, of course, but add some tricks, add some height to his airs. We'll see what he's got.
Yeah, the judges were not feeling that first run from Kowalski. Gave him a 71. He was able to stay on the whole run. He's gonna have to do something unique and special to bump that score up. Backsmith transfer.
You know, other than his giant transfers, he kind of does it quietly, does it? Sneaks into these big top spots.
Look at that slob plant off the extension, landing on that tricky hip section. Rolling out and rolling in. What's he setting up for?
10 more seconds.
Alley-oop backside air, under-rotated to the elbow.
It looked like he was on his way to a little bit better of a run, but just got a little lost there at the end.
I honestly feel like he might have been surprised at that score, and he kind of had to switch his lineup and do something else that he didn't plan on doing.
Jack Fardell now dropping in, currently in sixth place after a stellar first run.
We'll see if Jack is going for the same line that he did his first run, maybe try and add some more difficult tricks. I love that nose grind transfer he did out of the deep end. Look at this, coming in right on the hip. That is such a difficult re-entry spot. That is, it's such a rad line. He kind of whips frontside around the whole shallow section. That was unbelievable. That was like, I was blown away at how far it was in his first run, and that was like 10 feet further.
He was a man on a wire right there.
Love how he's able to keep his speed. Wow, he almost fell on the ollie to tail over the channel. Nose grind to fakie, fully hung.
Oh my God.
Oh my gosh. Pretty much the same run that he did his first time. He did grind the 5-0 to fakie way further. How are the judges going to reward that?
He just did everything a little bit better in that run, didn't he?
Yeah, he had a 78.63 his first run.
It'll be cool to see the difference in scores.
It really will be. 75. Some of that stuff was a little bit sketchy. Did the nose grind to fakie over the hip, and it wasn't as clean as his first run. Did the ollie to tail over the channel, got super sketchy. So it looks like judges aren't feeling the sketch points.
The judges don't fall for the hype like I do. I was fired up on that run. Here goes Curran Capel starting with a giant backside air.
Wow, that was like a million miles an hour front 5-0 through the corner.
He is built for this park.
Yeah, all the different grabs, tweaking out the lean melon to tail.
That was a surf-style bottom turn right there.
Came up a little bit short. He was trying to stay on. He didn't have the right line to do that frontside grind transfer. Tried to jump off the coping, smack it to disaster on the concrete.
Long legs, just like springs. He just starts, you see him building speed, and almost every trick he gets more speed out of it.
Yeah, speaking of springs for legs.
The unbreakable Aaron Jaws Hamoki.
Wow, kickflip Indy, squatting it out on the extension. Love that lean to tail stall.
I don't think anyone laughs at their own tricks more than Jaws.
Yeah, tongue is always hanging out. That's a rad nose grab 360 over the spine. As you know, Jaws is known for jumping off the biggest, longest things on the planet. Ollie down about 25 stairs in Lyon, France a few months ago. He's eyeing something up. What's he got?
Oh no, that's it.
Oh my gosh, off the quarter pipe on the backside of the extension.
5 seconds left.
Oh my gosh, almost splitting himself in half on the spine.
Again, no one has even looked at that quarter pipe until just then.
That was fun to watch. I don't think that's going to qualify for the finals. Taking out his boy, Joe Hamaki.
sorry,
Joe.
Me. All right, second run for Aaron Homoki. Jaws gets a 64.29, a little bit better. Needs to finish the run, and here we go. So far, underachieving, but we expect giant, sketchy things from Grayson Fletcher. Let's see it, Grayson.
Yeah, when he's able to put it together, it is a sight to see, man. It is so special. Super light-footed, feet are always flying off. You see that front foot fly off. Where is he going? It's like a demon unleashed in the deep end. Wow, everyone is struggling doing airs in that deep end.
And that was about to be an insanely high score for Grayson Fletcher. I mean, for me, the second he drops in, he is one of those guys that just, I'm scared for him. At the same time, I'm hyped for him, just because you'd never know what you're going to get. That was a great start, a 51.58, obviously vastly improving on the scores. He's in 13th place, out of qualification now, but he's got one more chance.
One more chance, that's all he needs. Now going down, both Kevin Kowalski and Jack Fardell. Looks like they need a little bit more to bump into this top eight.
So Kowalski focused, knowing he's got a job to do. What's he gonna start with?
Oh, the judo air got away from him. He's gonna have one more chance.
Never seen him fall on that trick.
I know.
So a bit of concern now.
Honestly, I feel like Kevin thought that first run was gonna be enough, and now he's sitting in eighth place with still a heat to go. Okay. So I think he just completely had to switch his plan up.
And he can't let it rattle him. Here we go, kind of in a similar position, thinking maybe his score should have been bigger. Jack Fardell now got something to prove to the judges.
Yeah, Jackson sixth, and the way we've seen the last couple contests, not everyone has been putting it together on that last heat, so could sixth place right now squeak into the top eight? We'll see.
We're going down with a lot of time to go. Jack Fardell, he's gonna have to
Jack was trying to switch it up. He made the run that he wanted to do. He knew that he had to switch it up, add some more difficulty in there. So that time he tried a completely different line.
Vans team rider, Curran Caples, rolling in, already going 1,000 miles an hour.
Yeah, Curran is just so fun to watch, man. He, every year that we did the Van Dorn Invitational down here, he was such a threat to win. Hasn't fully put it together this year on the Vans Park Series. He's been traveling and touring so much that he just really hasn't been able to focus on the contest grind too much.
So from Curran Caples, we go to everybody's favorite stuntman, Aaron Joss Homoki.
Another kickflip indie. That time he didn't have to squat it out. Rad start for Jaws. Would love to see him do that McTwist down in the deep end, but we've seen the deep end take everyone out. Normally, that would like blow someone's knee out, and that's like nothing for Jaws.
May have ripped his pants. I'm sure that happens often for Jaws. So Jaws is all right. And here we go, down to the wire, back to the top of the order. Last runs, Neil Hendricks, I'm stressing for Grayson Fletcher right now.
I know, man, I'm stressing for all these guys. I want to see Kowalski put it together as well. I would love to see more of these guys in the finals. Stay on, Grayson.
Grayson Fletcher, fourth and final run.
What a bummer. This is going to be strictly for the crowd right now. The judges, oh my gosh, he almost died even on that.
Man, he wants that first wall rebate, but that is reserved for the finals.
Yeah, first wall rebate is for the finals only, but I'm cool with watching more Grayson Fletcher, are you?
Absolutely. I would love a Grayson Fletcher intermission to see him skate. Well, that was not the result he wanted, we wanted, the Grayson Fletcher fans around the world, and there are a lot of them. That's gonna most likely be it for Grayson Fletcher. Kevin Kowalski now has one more opportunity. Gotta get his head in the game and put it all together for 45
Kowalski
seconds.
Kowalski has been in the finals at every Vans Park Series contest in history. He's on the bubble right now, not safe at all. Gotta pull something out to be in the finals later today.
Well, we know if he does make it, he's got tricks saved up.
Yeah, if he's got anything saved, he needed to pull it out now. Now it's gonna be up to the judges. He's currently in eighth. That is gonna be a risky proposition.
He's hanging by a thread when you got guys like Chris Russell, Ronnie Sandoval, Grant Taylor, and Raven Tershey coming up. Here we go, last looks for Jack Fardell.
Another guy who's pretty close to the bubble, currently in sixth place. Wants a little breathing room with all those heavy hitters coming in the next heat. See if he's going for that nose grind transfer. I love this trick right here. How does he do that every try? That is so gnarly. You have to be precise to like the centimeter on that trick.
Straight butter from Jack Fardell. Yes. God, that looks so cool.
You know, just comparing the skating today to the qualifiers yesterday, everyone ripped in the qualifiers yesterday, but just the speed and power among these select guys is next level compared to what we saw yesterday.
Well, you can just see why they've been selected. The precision, you know, yesterday there was thrashing going on. It was madness. Today, you see there's a little bit more of a calm approach, a precise kind of look to some of these guys. And Jack Fardell, a solid looking run, comes through to 68.91. He'll have to rely on that 78.63, a precarious position to be in. He's currently advancing, but we've got some heavy hitters coming up.
Currently on the outside looking in, he's in 11th place. Curran Caples needs to put it together.
Here we go, last run for Curran Caples.
Yeah, so smooth, different grabs over the hips. Look at that nose grind, nollie in with confidence. I love hearing the shoe drag on that 5-0. Wow, I thought he was gonna go to disaster.
he dodged a bullet right there.
Fully hung up. We've seen that deep in be the death of a lot of guys' runs.
He's
Curran is just smiling like, how did I make that? Frontside flip over the hip.
Yes, Curran.
This could be the money run for Curran Caples.
Frontside slash.
5 seconds to go. Needs to hang on for a couple more seconds. Wow, the backsmith washes out at time.
All right, put your judge's hat on. What do you think?
Hey, that frontside flip over the hip. You don't see anyone else in the contest doing that. I could see the judges giving that some love.
He needs a 71.63. Curran Caples fans around the world holding their breath. They want to see more. California's golden child. What's it going to be?
I'm on the edge of my seat. That is going to be really close to see how they judge that fall because it was right at time.
But taking some extra time, right? Thinking about this one.
I would be too. This is a big deal.
And there it is, an 83.38. Boom, third place for Curran Caples. What was it? What was it about that run?
It was that frontside flip. We know that all the grinds, all the lip tricks and airs that he does look perfect, but that frontside flip over the hip, that is so tech and so hard.
Last chance for Aaron Jaws Hamoki. We want to see a solid run finished with something psycho.
I can't believe that Jaws can do those kickflip indies on that extension that doesn't even quite go to vert. He does it every try. That is so sick. Oh, tough slam for Jaws, and that is going to be it for heat number three.
I'm scared of what Jaws is going to do if he does choose to be in the best trick contest.
Love it.
Oh, somebody just got the ultimate souvenir. Five people just got it. Have fun separating that pile.
Oh my gosh.
Fan participation. Here it is, your semifinals, current standings. Murillo Perez in that top spot. The only change we saw from that last heat, Curran Caples jumping up into third place. Jack Fardell worked his way up to seventh. Is he safe, Neil?
There's a big gap between Fardell and Zion Wright. So, you know, I still think that you're gonna need an 80. Like you said, look at this lineup in the last heat. We got Chris Russell, Ronnie Sandoval, Grant Taylor, Ben Hatchell is hurt. We're gonna see how he can perform. And Raven Tershey, it's gonna be precarious for Fardell to hold on.
More park madness to come. Stick around, we're gonna take a quick break. We'll be right back.
All right, right here, Crispy. This is the one.
Welcome back, Mid Park Series. We're live from Huntington Beach. An incredible skate park built right on the sand, right next to the pier, part of the Vans US Open of Surfing. Things have flared up.
Yeah,
since we just saw today.
Curran Caples come through under pressure, man. Pulled together, really amazing last run.
We're gonna go down to the deck, talk to our highest finisher of that last heat. Chris Pastris is with Curran Caples.
So, Curran, you completely hung up on that lean air. What was going through your mind?
I don't know. I was just going to try like a lean air to the tail smack, but then I was like, oh, I'm going to disaster. So I'm like, I'm just going to hang on and see what happens. Yeah, it was pretty sketchy.
And I think we've yet to see the Park Series finish we all know you're capable of. Are you feeling any added pressure to do well here because of that?
Yeah, I guess so. Like being this is the last event and then we go to Malmo. So yeah, I guess there's a little bit of pressure.
And I got to ask you about that kickflip. Was that planned over the hip there at the end of your run?
I tried it once in practice and it didn't really feel that great. And then that last run, I was like, I felt like going slow enough. So I just tried it.
Great run, Curran. Hope to see you in our finals. Back to you guys upstairs.
Thanks, Pastris. Congrats, Curran Caples. He could have probably done well in the surf contest as well.
You know what's really one of my favorite things to watch here at the U.S. Open is when Curran leaves practice every day and there's like 50 14-year-old girls waiting for him at the bottom of the stairs.
Here's your heat recap. Kind of a couple stunners in this one.
Yeah, look at Jack Vardell and Jaws 360 over the spine. Man, unfortunately, Kevin Kowalski is not going to be joining us in the finals, but had some highlights. Hopefully, Jack Vardell will. Curran Caples was able to make the magic happen on his very last run. Jaw squatted a couple out. Luckily, he's got springs for legs. Grayson was absolutely out of control and was not able to make it happen. But we always love watching Grayson, even if it's just in practice. That frontside flip was as good as it gets for Curran Caples. And Jaws gives the souvenir to Huntington Beach.
I wonder who got there. They're probably still wrestling over it. So from that recap of Heat 3, guess what? One of our favorite parts on ThrasherMagazine.com, the firing line. This is Chris Russell. Well, before we get there, seems like everyone's a firing line.
Yeah,
these guys put
I
it
saw
together.
Chris Gregson out here filming those firing lines with Ronnie Sandoval and Chris Russell a couple nights ago. It was so rad. Chris Gregson is so good at the follow cam. Can't wait to see these firing lines.
Check it out, Chris Russell, firing line. Something tells me, Neil Hendricks, that you saw that firing line before you made your skater picks. That was crazy.
Well, you know what? He filmed that on Wednesday afternoon, and in the couple days since then, Chris Gregson switched his lineup, and I think he, or I'm sorry, Chris Russell switched his lineup. I think he's got an even harder run that he's trying.
Semi-final, heat number four, super stacked. Chris Russell from Hermosa Beach, Ronnie Sandoval repping San Pedro, Grant Taylor from Atlanta, Georgia, Ben Hatchell from Manassas, and Raven Tershey from Santa Cruz, California. I'm sure all of you out there watching, one of your favorite skateboarders ever is in that group.
That's like a hall of fame of park skating right there. Chris Russell won our first stop down in Melbourne earlier. Grant Taylor, former skater of the year. Ronnie Sandoval is everyone's favorite.
Straight into it, Chris Russell's first run. We have high hopes for him, and we're scared for the park whenever he rolls in.
Look at that 5-0 to tail slide transfer.
And Raven, same for you.
huge lean disaster for Chris Russell. Yeah, I didn't see the eye of the tiger right there for Chris Russell. I think that was just his last practice run. Sorry for the switch up, little mix up right there. But yeah, Chris Russell has a totally different look in his eye when it's on for real.
You could tell the body language right there. He was kind of cruising after his first couple of tricks. 45 seconds to go. Now we're ready. Now we're gonna fire this up. Chris Russell, your first skater of heat number 4. Watch out.
Watch how different his whole attitude and mindset is when his contest run. Now is when he goes for blood.
Oh,
look
there
at
you
that
go.
Straight
there you
head frontside air. Watch, this is the frontside invert I was talking about. Nope, saving that one for the finals. Psych, huge lean disaster.
Now, is there a way that he lands that he doesn't break his board every single time?
Yeah, it's a total technique where you just have to land really over your front foot so your board almost bounces in. You can't have too much weight on the deck or you're gonna break your board like we saw the guys doing yesterday.
What do you think so far, Chris Russell's first run?
Yeah, needs a little bit more, but if he can stay on for 45 seconds, that boneless disaster was insane. He's got an eggplant. He's turned into such a good contest skater now.
There you go. There we see Chris Russell. I love the walk-off, too. Just what?
It's such a linebacker stance. He looks like a big, tough linebacker after the big tackle.
And then you see the totally different, more the jazz approach coming up. Ronnie Sandoval, again, super powerful skater, but you see the subtleties here, the style, a little bit more flow, whereas Chris Russell comes through trying to smash the park.
I never thought I'd see Chris Russell in surf trunks.
Yeah. Hey, you just shredded the
sixth
park.
Sixth place bumps Fardell down to 8th. Colin Graham is in 7th.
Ronnie Sandoval, some of the loosest trucks in the game and some of the best inverts. We hope to see those on display for Ronnie Sandoval.
I love it. Ronnie, he's like the mechanic, man. He looks like the dude that would fix your car. That's a perfect Smithvert. Ronnie's always got the Dickies gear. He's got Joe from Dickies always following him. Got the quadruple hop back boneless. Big air disaster in the deep end. Ronnie's been having so much fun in the sunset practice sessions with the boys. A little fast plant on the 8-foot wall. This is looking fun and smooth, but gonna need a little bit more to make the top 8.
Whoa!
Eggplant board got away. Another guy getting taken out by the tricky deep end.
Ronnie Sandoval, you gotta throw it all the way back to Melbourne where he did what we're pretty much considering one of the best frontside inverts ever.
Yeah, he has got such rad hand plants. But after that Eric Winkowski video part a few days ago,
battling him
now
for
we're kind of saying he is.
GT, the chosen one, Grant Taylor.
Man, it has been such a treat to watch GT in these practice sessions the last couple days. He's got lines over these hips that no one else can even step to, man. This, when it comes to some of the best that have ever done it in park skateboarding, this guy's at the top of the list.
Now, I've heard in the past that Grant Taylor will show up at contests, and if he doesn't like the park, he won't even skate.
Yeah, well, seems to be digging this one. I saw him pointing out a couple of things that he didn't like with it yesterday. Body varial disaster. Never seen that one before. Backside 360 ollie. This is a rad first run for Grant Taylor. 5 more seconds. Can he stay on? Alley-oop half cab over the hip. That was a rad run for GT.
And he stayed on his board. You know, we saw him in Brazil. He had a little bit of trouble just staying on for the total 45 seconds, but right there, he did it.
Hey,
already.
I think out of the 3 Park Series stops that he's showed up to, I think that's the first time we've seen Grant pop out after a full pull of 45 seconds.
So waiting for scores for Grant Taylor. I mean, win or lose, he will always be on the list of everybody's
Yeah.
all-time favorite. 75.01. That's
still
enough for 9th place.
Needs a little bit more to make it into the finals. That's how tough the cut is. Grant Taylor can make a run and still be on the outside looking in.
Ben Hatchell, you saw the slam from earlier. Doesn't look like he's going to be too affected. The technician rolls into the park.
Yeah, Ben separated his shoulder just on Thursday evening. You saw the big slam in our park preview. Yoda accidentally dropped in on him, smashed his shoulder. diagnosed as a separated shoulder, but he said he's gonna give it a go.
Yeah, he said, I don't need my shoulder to skate.
Look at that, front feeble. I gotta tell you honestly, from watching practice at the beginning of the week, Hatchell was my pick, and after that slam, I was like, I gotta switch it up, but Hatchell's looking like he's still a pretty good bet to make it into the finals. How about this run with one arm?
You know, it looks to be like he's lessened the tech game a little bit and kind of moved over towards the kind of the power skating.
Yeah, he just doesn't want to take a slam. That's what it is.
I wouldn't either. The slam he took in that video was harsh.
Hey, I think that's going to be enough to make the top eight. That was a really good first run for Ben Hatchell.
And what, does he not dig heavy metal? What does he listen to, country music?
Don't know, man.
We'll have to ask him. We'll see what this score brings him. Ben Hatchell, as we wait. This is where he's wondering, did I do enough? 80.82. Well,
wow.
That's enough for a qualification spot.
It is
seventh
now.
Place. Yeah, this is the last heat of the semi. So after this, that's where we're going to get our top eight.
Yeah, but there's still Ronnie and Grant
don't let
and those
me forget.
Guys. Yeah, and Raven.
Raven Tershey, a perennial favorite, especially here in Huntington Beach. Power skating at its finest. Here we go.
Raven has won here on the beach in Huntington before, back when it was Van Dorn Invitational, but not able to start out the way he wanted.
Couple past champions in this heat.
Yeah, he is just full speed attack, man. Raven has one mode, and it is kill.
All right, we're back to the top of the list. Chris Russell wants to do to this park what that guy on his tattoo is doing to that other guy. He wants to smash it.
Currently in sixth place, so in a finals qualifying spot. Look at that boneless, trying to smack the tail on the way in. Full speed attack, frontside air disaster. This is the Chris Russell. That's not even a disaster. He just locked his truck on.
Killer, killer shot right there going around that corner.
Can't get over the surf trunks, man. Not what I expected from the Creature team. Think Creature's making those surf trunks?
We're on the beach, man. Whoa!
Oh, almost sliding out with 5 seconds to go. Ollie DeSmith up the extension. Crail disaster shooting out right at time.
Wow, solid, solid run for Chris the Muscle Russell.
You know,
used to be called Nemesis, but now we can just call him the Muscle.
In practice, I saw him trying every run. He was doing this frontside invert transfer out of the deep end onto the extension. I wonder if he's just holding that for finals.
76.12. He's in sixth place.
I do think it's a good strategy to maybe hold a hammer for the finals. You just got to make sure that you make the finals.
Ronnie Sandoval, one of the smoothest to ever do it from San Pedro. Channel Street local, we'll see what he's got here in Huntington.
Half the contest yesterday was from Pedro. They're all trying to be like this guy. Love those inverts, such rad style on that. 80s influence in Ronnie skating, but with a super cool modern style.
Great disposition too, mellow. Super nice.
Yeah, nicest guy ever. Everyone loves Ronnie. I love that frontside air. Looked like he was trying to decide if he was going to disaster, going to tail. Unfortunately, got away from him.
So yet to put it completely together.
Hey, this is going to be good. GT's already made a run. He's on the outside looking in. Needs to bump it up a little bit to make the finals. I think we're gonna see something special.
Yeah, hopefully he feels a little freed up to get loose, and here we go, straight into it, over the death box.
Yeah, that's such a rad way to start your run. Backside ollie over the channel. Huge frontside air. Looked like he barely snuck it in under the coping. Shot out in the flat.
Wow, so Grant Taylor, polar opposite of his first run, goes down quick. Here we'll see Ben Hatchell. We'll see if he gets back to his winning ways. A past champion here in Huntington Beach. Here we go, 45 seconds on the clock for Ben Hatchell.
He's in seventh place, so there are a couple guys that could bump him out, going for the kickflip stale over the channel. That's one of his trademarks. He knows he's got to add some difficulty to get further up in the rankings.
So Ben Hatchell skating, of course, again, with that separated shoulder and if you've ever had that, it's not easy to do anything, let alone rip a park.
It is a nightmare to skate with a separated shoulder.
Raven Tershey, his first run was a throwaway. We'll see what he's got in his second go.
Look how fast Raven is going. Huge ollieing into the indie grab. So hard to control your speed going that fast. Alley-oop 5-0 puts the front truck down into a 50-50. This could be the run that Raven wants. The frontside air into the deep end. That is such a gnarly line, blasting off that hip into the deep end. I thought that was going to be the run for Raven.
You could tell he just started to get a little bit off right after that alley-oop. He wanted it to be straight 5-0, but he kind of tapped. And that's where things started going awry. Here's your top eight from the semifinals so far. Murillo Perez with that 85.44. That is the benchmark. Colin Graham, as of now, he snuck in to qualification with Ben Hatchell in seventh, Chris Russell in sixth, Tom Schaar, Tristan Rennie. They appear to be safe at this point.
Yeah, but a few of those guys, Murillo, Tom Schaar, Colin Graham, they're going for those challenger spots to make it to Malmo.
A lot at stake here today in Huntington Beach. Here goes Chris Russell.
Currently in sixth place, so he's in at the moment, but not completely safe with a few guys in this heat still on the outside.
Flying. I mean, he is a bull in a china shop right now.
It's so rad. Just the way that he holds his shoulders, it's like he's going to break the park. See if he's going to do that front invert right here. Nope, still going under the lip on the extension. Love that nose grab, air to fakie. Saw his buddy Willie Lara pulling that one out in the qualifying yesterday also. Wow, Roland Reaver, that is so hard.
Hanging on.
Man, acid drop to Reaver in a 9 foot deep concrete vert deep end is so sketchy.
He is angry. Pretty radical how close the judges are to all the skaters too. There's a lot of just aggression coming out of these guys as they pull out. There you see he kind of lost where the park was. He fell in the pool.
Check it out, that's Danny Way.
Yeah.
That is so rad.
Oh, that rules. Chris Russell waiting for score. Look, Danny Way is giving it up. Props from Danny Way. That's probably better than a win right there.
That's awesome, man.
Looking towards the scoreboard. Waiting for it. There you have it, an 86.29. Wow. Chris Russell is our new leader.
New leader. It doesn't change who's in the top eight, but really shuffles the standings. Look at that high five from Ben Hatchell. High five from all the boys. Ronnie Sandoval, no high fives from him. He's got to get ready to go to work.
45 seconds on the clock. Come on, Ronnie, put this together.
Currently in 15th place. Needs an 80 to bump into the top eight, but Colin Graham is sitting in eight, sweating it out.
A little quick 1 foot right there.
Wow, finger flip lean to tail. The deep end claims another victim.
And Ronnie is the king of cool. I've actually talked to his dad. He's a super fan, not only of Ronnie, but surfing. He's into the whole deal, no doubt watching.
Dude, I love the big Ronnie Sandoval head that they got down there on the deck.
Grant Taylor getting ready for it. He's had one amazing run, one throwaway. Let's see if he can put it all together here. Former Skater of the Year for Thrasher Magazine, Grant Taylor.
I think he's going to put it together. Sorry, Colin Graham.
I hope so.
But wow, ollie to pivot, transfer. Look at that frontside ollie. That was so floated over the deck. He has such a rad style when he squats out of those airs, taking the front foot off on the whippy back D.
20 seconds.
Oh my gosh. Looked like he just lost his line right there. Tried to go for a back tail over the hip and slid out.
Kind of got the reverse thing going here. Starts off so crazy and kind of slid and peters out towards the end.
Yeah, that was weird. It looked like once he kind of maybe had a weird landing and kind of lost his speed and wasn't able to get it back.
Ben Hatchell, can the technician put it together here? Love to see some of his flip trick variations.
Yeah, Betty goes for that kickflip stale again. Nope. Whoa. Front feeble to fakie. That is so gnarly.
How are you going to come in fakie when you got a separated shoulder?
No one is doing a front feeble to fakie over that transfer. Out of the deep end, all the way over the hip. So Ben is in seventh place right now, but with Raven and GT and some of those guys still out of the top eight, he could get bumped. switch frontside air. That is going to be some love from the judges. Alley-oop, chink, chink, grind.
Now this is the Ben Hatchell we know and love.
Is he going to flip his board on that kickflip stalefish? What? Is that
out? Do you think that's going to hurt him? I mean, he put together a crazy run.
That run was insane. He had switch tricks. The front feeble to fakie. Can't wait to see that in the replay highlights.
Wow, so.
I mean, that's a front feeble over like 20 feet to fakie.
He shouldn't even be skating today. Look at this. You see the bandage kind of under right there? Skating with a separated shoulder and absolutely
against
shredded.
Doctor's orders as skateboarders. Oh, look at that.
83.95 for Ben Hatchell, as we expected.
Even with that fall, and I think that's good, man, because he did some really hard tricks before that fall right at the end.
Some crazy transfers that we've yet to see as well. Here goes Raven Tershey.
Worth noting, Colin Graham is still alive on the bubble in eighth, and Tom Schar is now in the hot seat in seventh, and Raven is still on the outside looking in.
All right, where we're going to go back to the top of the order. This is where it all comes down. Chris Russell, he's done enough. He's qualified. He's currently sitting in first place, but he's never one to take it easy.
Nah.
There you see the top eight. Chris Russell, Murillo Perez, Oscar Rosenberg, Hallberg safe. Ben Hatchell climbs to fourth. Capels in fifth. Tristan Rennie in sixth. Tom Schar seven. Colin Graham in that precarious eighth place spot. Neil Hendricks, this has been a shocker of a heat, and it just keeps on going. Chris Russell's final run.
Yeah, I'm curious to see if he maybe tries some of his stuff for the finals. Nope. You know
save
what?
It. Save it up.
That
save
was kind of a throwaway. I think he's still got a couple tricks in the bag for the finals. Didn't even want to break them out. Didn't even want to show the judges those tricks in the semifinals. So
here we go. Last chance for one of the coolest cats currently riding a skateboard on this planet. Ronnie Sandoval. Here we go. Final run.
Yeah, huge surprise to see Ronnie still in 15th. At our first stop in Melbourne, he actually had the highest score out of the semifinals. Wasn't able to put it together in the finals, but we saw what he's capable of, making the stalefish in the deep end. We've seen this deep end get so many guys. Looked like he was going to hang on that backside air. Slop plant disaster on the 8-foot wall.
God, he makes skateboarding look good, doesn't
he? Wow, looked like he was going to get shot off on that back lip. Under 10 seconds to go. Can Ronnie hang on?
We need a strong finish here.
Yeah, how is this going to compare to Colin Graham?
Wow.
I think it's going to be really, really close.
I would hate to be a judge right now. That is heavy.
Did not make it easy for the judges. Colin Graham is sitting in eighth with an 80.01. Ronnie is on the outside. Needs an 80.02. I think it's going to be really close.
I mean, so smooth. Again, using the whole park. No wall was left untouched in that run.
Hey, and there again.
And there's a giant Ronnie Sandoval head on. There you have
He's in.
Squeaked in eighth place, Ronnie Sandoval. But wait, folks. Three more skaters to go. This is getting hectic.
He could still get bumped out by Grant or Raven. But Colin Graham, hit the showers, buddy. Great skating all week, but unfortunately not going to be able to advance.
Last chances for GT Grant Taylor from Atlanta, Georgia. Here we go.
Love that start, man. Always really unique lines. Look at that frontside air. That is head high on that extension.
It's cool to see two of the most stylish skateboarders in the world back to back like that.
Yeah, this heat is so stacked. Look at that, off the teardrop, onto the spine. This is Grant putting it together. Look at that, just that's like a carve over the spine, and Grant blows out through the corner.
You could tell he wanted it in that run. You can really tell when Grant wants it when he's just cruising.
Yeah, just over the spine, that front side to backside quick whip grind is like, I would love to just be able to do that so easy like Grant does.
All right, so here we go. We've got Ben Hatchell.
Hatchell
his
now
final run.
Guaranteed to be in the finals. He's currently in fourth, so he cannot get bumped out.
He's got a chill right here, I would
say. Yeah, no kidding. He cannot afford to take a big slam on that shoulder. Not sure if he has been looking at the scoreboard to know that he's in.
Yeah, I don't. He doesn't look like he's skating mellow, does he?
Yeah, not sure if the announcers there on the deck are telling him that he's in. But
tell him to stop.
Yeah, chill, please. We want to see you in one piece. And
all right.
That's, what? How did he? We thought that
there's
he was
no bailing. Comply out.
That was insane.
You wow.
Hear, Clements and Tim O'Connor regulating on the deck of the park.
They will call you out on a questionable make, but just like that, Ben Hatchell, he's safe. Here we go. Nothing safe about this guy's attack when it comes. Here we go, Raven Tershey, last chance.
This is the last skater of the semis. It's either gonna be Raven Tershey or Ronnie Sandoval, who's in eight. Look at this run. If Raven makes this run, it's gonna have to be in the 80s, but can he stay on for 45 seconds? No, Raven Tershey, hit the showers, buddy.
Wow, so generally a trick he's got on lock every time Raven Tershey goes down. But with that, your fourth and final heat of the semifinals. The smooth one, Ronnie Sandoval, rolling on into the finals in eighth place. And there you have it. We've got our final list of skaters here in the Vans Park Series. A lot of pro select skaters still left in competition. Chris Russell, Murillo Perez, keep your eyes on him. He could potentially qualify for Malmo right now. Curran Capel's down in fifth. Tristan Rennie, another qualifier from yesterday. Tom Schar and Ronnie Sandoval rounding it out in eighth place.
Quick shout out to Colin Graham, who barely got bumped out. Great skating from the young kid from Virginia Beach, and Jack Fardell, who ended up in 10th. Those guys were super close to making it to the finals.
And don't forget, folks, it's not all about just this event. We've had previous events on the Vans Park Series. We're gonna take all the points, and we're gonna figure out all qualifiers. We're gonna take a quick break. We'll be right back. We're going to the finals. Stay tuned.
At the iconic Manly Beach. To find out more, go to sydney.com.
All right, right here, Crispy. This is the one.
Welcome back. We're headed to the finals here in Huntington Beach. Fourth stop in the Vans Pro Skate Park Series. I'm feeling supported right now because of this Waffle Cup. Of course, Kyle Walker's new pro model shoe. Incredible.
I love seeing the Vans Park Series watch and win. We always scroll through at the end of the day to see where everyone's watching from. So appreciate everyone tuning in from around the world. Someone's gonna win these shoes.
Where are you watching? How are you watching? Tell us, show us at Vans Park Series. Hashtag Vans Park Series. We don't have a winner yet, so you could still win this pair of tested, tried, and true incredible skate shoes. If your name's on a Vans shoe, you rip, and we know Kyle Walker is one of the best. All right, how did we get here? Where did we come from? We started the Vans Pro Skate Park Series down under in Melbourne, Australia. We went from there to Florianopolis. Just got back from Vancouver, Canada. Now we're in Huntington Beach, California. We're leading up to the Global Championships, the first ever Global Championships Park Series, Neil.
Could we have a repeat winner in Chris Russell? Are we gonna have someone completely new that has never won a Park Series? Pedro Barros and Yvonne Federico, the other winners, did not make it to the finals here. So it's going to be Chris Russell's the only one that could add a second Park Series crown. And we're going to go on to Malmo in 3 weeks.
Well, speaking of the devil, Chris Russell is on the deck with another Chris. Chris Pastris.
Chris Russell, sitting in first place right now. How are you feeling, buddy?
Man, it feels so good. Just, a lot of emotion going on right now. Pretty crazy. Just trying to focus up and doing all that. So it was pretty, insane to bump up like that. I was tripping out, so I'm stoked, man.
And I know you've been at all our events. You seem laser focused at this one. What's the deal with that?
Well, I'm just pretty stoked since we're in California, you know, kind of close to home. It's a lot easier kind of being like my own element and all that. Plus, it kind of helps. The grandparents are here right now, so I want to make them proud and do all that.
Are the grandparents keeping you out of trouble?
Yeah, a little bit, but they're pretty cool, so I can get in a little bit of trouble, you know?
Yeah. Props to the Russell grandparents. And you've been to all our stops. Which has been your favorite one so far, Chris Russell?
Man, I love this stop every year. It just brings in like such a good energy, good vibe, all these people, you know? It's a good time. This whole week's just kind of like hectic and fun. Everybody flies into town, you know, meets up. So I'm stoked. I love this time.
I got to squeeze in one more question. Are we going to see the gap to frontside invert?
Ooh, maybe. I don't know. We'll see.
Chris Russell, first place in semifinals so far. Good luck in finals, brother. Back to you guys.
Yeah, but all the Chris's are fired up down here today.
Better do that gap to frontside invert. I've been talking about it for the whole webcast.
You put it in print.
Yeah.
And there you have it, Neil Hendricks' pick going in. That was a solid pick. And like you said, he stays out of trouble when he's close to home. Yeah. Sight to see him, you know, showing emotion. We know he's a badass, but that's cool. He's got a heart.
Every morning in Australia and Brazil, I would hear the Chris Russell stories from the night before. Somehow he was able to pull it off and win the contest in Australia, but doesn't always work. Didn't work for him in Florianopolis, that's for sure.
Here's the Chris Russell story from today, your recap from our final semifinal.
Love that floaty boneless and huge frontside disaster. Ronnie Sandoval got the big head with D Vargs and the buttery frontside invert. Alley-oop 5-0 just barely putting the front truck down for Raven Tershey. I cannot believe Chris Russell can just smash everything to disaster. Roll in revert. So gnarly to hang on. And how about this guy? It is just such a treat to watch GT skate the Vans Park Series. Front feeble to fakie for Ben Hatchell.
I don't want it to sound weird, but I could just watch Grant Taylor pump around this park for 24 hours straight.
I'm with you, dude. It is so fun to watch.
And I'm pretty surprised that Raven Tershey didn't qualify for the finals. He seems like a walkthrough every time.
You know, the thing is, he is just going so fast. It is so on edge that it is so hard to stay on for 45 seconds when you're just going Mach 10.
The good news for Raven Tershey fans, he is one of our select pros here in the Vans Park Series, so you will no doubt see him in Malmo, Sweden.
Hey, did you see that sign? It said Winkowski's runs matter. Eric Winkowski doing it for Santa Cruz put out one of the most insane park video parts a few days ago. Check it out on ThrasherMagazine.com if you haven't. Eric Winkowski's run does matter.
Well, speaking of ThrasherMagazine.com, we want to get you guys psyched. Here is a firing line. The one and only Ronnie Sandoval. Are back. We are ready for the finals here in Huntington Beach, California, as part of the Vans U.S. Open of Surfing. This is the Vans Pro Skate Park Series, and that is Christian Asoy hanging with the big dog right there.
Down with big head, Ronnie. That is so cool. Christian's sons, Endless and Classic down there. Those kids have been ripping, man. Endless and Classic have got so much better.
Yeah, definitely go to Christian's Instagram to check them out. They rip. All right, the nuts and bolts of the final. We switch a few things up here. 4 runs each. That's the same. 45-second runs. Skate until you fall. Here's the kicker. The first wall rebate. That's when this comes into play, the finals. What does that mean, Neil? What do you have there?
Yeah, that means you can try a really hard trick on your first trick. If you miss it, your run restarts. The clock resets. You can you can't drop in and try it again. It only is good once per run.
One time. One get-out-of-jail-free card. Here's your judging criteria. Put all these things together for us, Neil. Put it in context. How do you win this contest?
Yeah, difficulty of tricks, style, speed, consistency, use of the park. You've seen how we have this tricky deep end and the shallow section. The judges are going to want to see at least a couple big tricks in that deep end, but you got to get out of there. Can't get stuck half piping down there. These are the guys in the finals.
Here is your final. Ronnie Sandoval, Tom Schaar, Tristan Rennie, Curran Caples, Ben Hatchell, Oscar Rosenberg, Halberg, Mario Perez, and Chris Russell. Keep your eye out for Tom Schaar, Tristan Rennie, and Mario Perez. They are your three potential qualifiers for Malmo. They got to finish strong here.
Those guys were not some of the Park Series Select Pros, so they are part of our Challenger point rankings. They're trying to be in the top eight of the challengers to make it to Malmo. It originally was going to be five, but we have Riley Hawk out with an injury, Rowan Zarilla out with an injury, Colin Provost can't make it, so we're taking eight to Malmo out of the challengers.
Wow. The drama builds. Here we go. We're going to start this off with Smooth Cat. Ronnie Sandoval, 45 seconds on the clock. Here we go. Let's start the finals.
The Mechanic. I want to see if that nickname can stick, man. He just looks like the dude that would be fixing your motorcycle, fixing your car, fixing your big Crail the Tail. Such a rad style. Every single trick he does is just perfect. Looking casual right here. What's he got in the deep end? Big indie air. We've seen that deep end claim a lot of victims. Perfect boneless on the 8-foot wall, back to the deep. Oh, that's the patented frontside invert.
I almost jumped out of my chair right there. One of the coolest tricks you're ever likely to see, a big, fully stalled out frontside invert from Ronnie Sandoval. That was Ronnie's first run here in the finals. He's gonna set the tone for what we're about to see, a 66.90. It's enough for first now, but you can bet no 60s are gonna make this cut. This is all about getting 90s for the win. No more advancing here. It's all about the title.
I would say the only other thing is you wanna be on that podium. If you're not gonna win, you wanna be in that top three.
Here we go, Tom Schaar, 16 years old, in the final, starting strong.
Yeah, Tom Schaar was able to squeak into the final. Didn't completely put together a perfect run in the semis, but was able to do those 540s in the deep end, bumped him into the top eight.
Yeah, you might be wondering, yes, he's doing the same run over and over, but it's all about one solid run. The best one run counts of four.
Flipping his board, kickflip Indy over the hip. That's the first time I've seen him do that, even in practice.
That's an add-on. That's what the judges want to see.
Front feeble through the corner. See if he goes for that 540 again. Front blunt, still just a couple seconds to go. Wow, he was able to get out of the deep end. That was a really good first run. Backside 360. Wow.
Almost the perfect run. Put together a string of insane tricks.
Yeah,
just couldn't quite hold on to the end.
Love that Tom is throwing some new ones out there. Didn't see him doing the kickflip indie over the hip at all week.
And what do you think of that decision not to throw the 540 in?
I think he planned on it. I think that the frontside air into the deep end, I think he just landed a little bit low and didn't have a good setup. I think he did plan on doing the 540, just didn't get a good landing.
78.76, that bumps him into first place, but of course tons of skating yet to come. So we move down the list. We're looking at Tristan Rennie. What are his strengths and weaknesses, Neil?
Hey, I think his strengths are that nose grind through the corner. He's also been doing 540s over the hip.
Here we go. Tristan Rennie with 45 seconds on the clock. He starts off with your favorite trick.
I love that trick, man. He almost came to a full stop and was still able to nollie in.
I love that he started with his hardest trick of his run. That opens him up, frees him up to get wild.
When you got first wall rebate, that's the other trick I mentioned. He's got that 540 over the hip every try.
Tristan Rennie, so far so good. 20 seconds left.
Love that front feeble on the 8-foot wall. already close to the end of his run. What's he got? You see him squinting in the deep end. The sun gets really tricky at this time of day. See the shadows.
Yeah, the shadows wreaked havoc on some of our women at this time of the day, so we'll see if it hinders any of our men.
This is gonna be time right here. Looked like he was going for an invert revert. Don't think that fall will hurt him too much. Really curious to see where that puts him compared to Tom Schaar.
So what did he add to his run just then to just
I think he just put everything together. He started with the nose grind, like you said, also threw in that perfect 540 over the hip, all of his good lip tricks like the front feeble. That was a good run for Tristan.
Waiting for scores. He is looking up at the big screen, and he likes what he sees, an 82.74. Third skater, another new leader.
Yeah.
It's gonna be flip-flopping this entire final. Curran Caples blasted through the park in semis. Finds himself now staring down the barrel of a potential massive finish. Here we go, Curran Caples.
Yeah, he got a little lucky also because he did a lean air in the deep end where he fully hung up in the semifinal, somehow made it and powered through. Look at that line into the deep end. That was such a tricky combo. Wow, lean melon to tail in the deep end, out of the deep end with speed.
And I love those, just the little taps at the end of those giant airs.
Oh, the frontside flip did not work. That's the trick that got him through the semis.
All right, well, that was your first halfway run. Curran Caples, Ben Hatchell. I think he's been saving a little bit of his tech abilities up for the finals.
You see him stretching that shoulder out. If you didn't see our park preview from earlier, took a huge slam. Got collided, got dropped in on one of our crazy practice sessions.
Ben Hatchell, first run in the finals. Here we go, 45 seconds.
Just trying to skate through the pain. 540,
what?
Transfer.
The hell just happened?
Oh my gosh. He did that in previous years at Van Dorn Invitational, but that wall, oh my gosh. Luckily that wasn't on his bad shoulder.
Jeez.
Now he's got two bad shoulders. I was gonna say the 540 that he did on that wall, you might have seen him do that at Van Dorn Invitational last year, but that wall is way shorter this year. It's much harder to do that trick here in 2016.
A finals appearance, finally here for Oscar Rosenberg Halberg from Malmo, Sweden, 19 years old, super stylish. He goes very, very fast. Watch out, Park, here we go.
Oh, love that alley-oop 50-50 kind of Raven Tershey influence on that one. We saw Raven doing that trick as well. Yeah, I'd say he's probably looking like the fastest guy in the park, except for Raven. Since we don't have Raven in the finals, we'll do with Oski. Backside 360 transfer. I've never seen anyone do that trick.
And did it perfect.
I mean, you have to travel about 20 feet to go from bowl to bowl in that section of the park.
Our announcers on the deck are losing it.
Hey,
we got Tim O'Connor and Ryan Clements.
Straight shifty over the spine. This is gonna be a new leader for sure. This run is insane.
Wow, Oscar Rosenberg Halberg finishing.
Wow, that is gonna be a monster score. The kid from Malmo put it together in Huntington Beach.
I said it earlier, he's been in the van for 2 weeks straight with Grant Taylor with a huge, just influential group of guys, and the confidence shows there.
Hey, this is gonna be a monster score, man. This is gonna be a tough one to beat. Look up at the screen right now, because we're gonna see a big number, 86.24.
Another new leader. Oscar Rosenberg Halberg, Oski for short, from Malmo, Sweden. One of our, you know, kind of like dark horse Park Select pros, and he is making that selection. Totally feel like it was meant to be.
It's funny, because when the list of Park Series Select Pros came out, a few people said to me,
who?
Hey, why'd you guys pick Oski to be? And I was like, wait
and
see. That's why we picked Oski to be in the Select 15.
Here's your top five. Oscar Rosenberg Halberg, Tristan Rennie, Tom Schaar, Ronnie Sandoval, and Curran Caples, 86.24 being the highest score yet. Well, this guy was dropping high 80s in the semis, ripped through a crazy qualifier.
I think
Mario Perez.
Oski and Raven were the fastest guys in the park. I forgot about Murillo. Watch this.
Straight into it. Murillo Perez.
Oh, that's a first wall rebate. so we'll be able to get a restart on Murillo Perez.
Yeah, so there's the rule. You see the clock, it resets itself. Murillo gets to reset his run, but he used it on his first run. So that could come back to haunt him.
Yeah, you can use it again. You just get one per run. Got the tail slide transfer to start it off. Wow, look at that Stalefish floating all the way into the corner. Stoked to see we got a Brazilian represented in the finals. The whole Brazil crew's been coming down to all the Vance Park Series stops. Unfortunately, no Pedro at this stop, but I know, wow, that was a monster slam. Stalefish disaster for Murillo.
Taking a minute to get up. Of course, we have an incredible emergency crew on
staff. How did he get up from that? Are you kidding me?
Dude is made of steel. That's how they build them down in Brazil. They're made of iron.
Wow, stoked to see Murillo get up from that. That was a head smash on a Stalefish disaster. We have seen the disaster tricks take so many guys out on that section of the park.
You know, for contests, you look at Hastings and you kind of think Sorgente. When I think Huntington, I think Murillo Perez.
Yep.
Chris Russell, your first place qualifier coming into the finals. Of course, we reset everything. Here we go from Hermosa Beach, California. Chris, the muscle, Russell.
Top qualifier out of the semifinals. Frontside air revert.
Whoa.
Gosh.
That was scary. So was that a first wall rebate?
Yeah, that's first wall rebate. They're not going to count just pumping around for speed. So he's going to get a rebate on that one. I love the first wall rebate because these guys are able to try really hard tricks to start off their run. You might get a first wall rebate, but you're still going to feel that slam. It's not easy to jump straight in after taking a slam like that.
Well, Chris Russell, he is a warrior. Here we go.
Is he going to go for the same trick again? Yes.
Of course.
Of course he is. And the
same outcome.
Exact same slam.
He's kind of surprised, I think, because he's got that trick on
lock. But man, I don't know where he was going to go going fakey with all that speed towards that hip. I think the hardest thing about that trick is what you do going backwards after you land it.
Back to the top of the order, Ronnie Sandoval. He's at 86.25.
Currently in fourth place after that solid first run. Indy Air gets away from him.
And I think he had maybe done a couple quick tricks. So we'll see right there. All right, no, it was I believe his second trick. So we're straight over to Tom Schar. Tom Schar, stellar last run. And there he uses the first wall rebate.
Yep.
Clock resets itself. I like the way he's trying to start this run, though.
Yeah, I love that Tom Schar knows he's got to do some really difficult tricks. It was really important for him to qualify for the finals in Malmo. I think now that he made the finals, he's pretty safe there.
Tom Schar back at it. Switches it up a little bit, starts a little bit safer, although that trick is very unsafe.
Yeah, still a boosted, perfect Stalefish. Alley-oop judo over the channel. Wow, backside ollie, not able to stay under him. Looked like he got a little bit over the front foot on the backside ollie.
I feel like a lot of times, you know, the field comes in so hot for the semis, knowing how hard it is to make that cut, that they almost start to run out of steam sometimes in their first couple runs.
Almost a relief just to make it to the finals.
Tristan Rennie now, we'll see what he can do for his second run here.
Yeah,
Vance Park Series.
Great first run, currently in second. Starting his run a little different. We saw him do the nose grind through the corner to start it off last time. Definitely one of the highest scoring tricks he's got in his run. Nose grind, he completely hung up. He did not mean to do a nose grind disaster, and he did not mean to smash on his chest on the frontside air to Smith.
Things are getting slammy here in the finals. Tristan Rennie sitting in second place, and right there taking a pretty hard slam. Curran Caples will take his second run. Has yet to put it together in the finals, but we're still early. We'll see what Curran Caples has.
I think it's all gonna be about that frontside flip over the hip. If he can make his whole run, he's got really rad tricks. Look at that nose grind, nollying in. He's got so much rad stuff, but I feel like that frontside flip is something that no one else in the finals has. Popping out of that 5-0, This is a rad line for Curran.
Looked like he was thinking about that frontside flip a minute ago, but maybe just missed his line a little bit.
Love hearing the pool coping blocks clacking. Wow, he was going for the frontside flip in the deep end.
It looked like he had it. It was sucked up to his feet.
Yeah, he caught it. Perfect.
All right, so Curran Caples. Right now, he is sitting in sixth place. This dude's kind of now become...
He's hurt,
He's gotten on my list of badasses for sure.
Every time we have the camera on Hatchell, you see him stretching his shoulder out, stretching his neck out. He took a monster slam a couple days ago. We all thought for sure he wasn't going to be able to skate.
Here we go, Ben Hatchell fighting through the pain, hoping for the win.
We had our alternate. Oh, man, the 540 just under-rotated. First wall rebate.
Well, the good news is he kind of slid out of that nicely. Yeah, it wasn't a super harsh slam.
But our first alternate for the semifinals was Patrick Ryan, and we told Patrick this morning, hey, practice. We don't think that Ben Hatchell's going to be able to skate. He separated his shoulder, probably not going to be able to go. Hatchell shows up and is just killing it.
That's funny. He doesn't look like the toughest dude, but I'll tell you what, this dude is made of rocks.
Yeah, I've seen this dude take slams, decides against doing the 540. Love that back tail, though.
Another guy, soft-spoken, super cool on the
disaster.
Deck. Skates like a banshee.
Front hurricane on the extension, this is a good one.
Now you can start to see when he builds his momentum, you know, he just starts to get more and more comfortable in the park.
All of these lip tricks are so hard, man. Kickflip frontside air.
Oh, he lost it for a second. I thought he made it.
Yeah, out of the deep end, all the way over the hip, kickflip frontside air. That is so tricky.
So when you fall, your run is over, unless it's on that first wall. We're throwing first wall rebates for every run here in the finals. Oscar, Rosenberg, Halberg. You would think the underdog coming into this, he is currently sitting in first place. Yeah. Oski with 45 seconds on the clock.
Would you have thought we'd be halfway through the finals with our Swedish Ripper at the top of the leaderboard? Now doing a completely different line, tail slide transfer over the bank, high speed 50-50 in the deep. Wow. Oh. He is staying on to everything. You heard those wheels bark. Back nose blunt went completely wrong. Somehow he held on.
Oski is putting it all together. 18 seconds left.
Oh my gosh, he was going for back tail revert, completely stuck. That is such a hard trick to bail out of.
Remember, best run counts. That was Oski's second run. Two more skaters to go on their second turns. Of course, everybody gets four runs here in the finals. We're gonna go back to Brazil with Murillo Perez coming back from a vicious slam.
Backtail revert is just so committed. There's no getting out of it.
Here we go, Murillo.
Love that backsmith to tail slide. Good to see that Murillo's up and in one piece after that monster slam on the Stalefish disaster. There's a backtail transfer.
And it appears that he's completely forgotten about that slam.
Yeah, no kidding. Look at this. Body jar on the extension. Now pumping for speed frontside. Wow, Stalefish, that was completely over-rotated. I thought he was going to revert for a second.
That was freakish that he managed to stay on his board.
Gosh, gap into the deep end with a Smith grind.
Oh, he had 8 seconds to go, and
front
he fell.
Feeble did not lock into the corner.
Oh, man, we are looking at a crazy run for Murillo. I think he's still going to get a lot of points there, but had he made that last trick, we would have been looking at a 90 for sure.
Yeah, that was a great run.
Murillo, he's hoping he had just stayed on his board for literally 4 more seconds.
Luckily, has 2 more shots for that victory run.
There you see the scores. The judges right behind him locking in their scores. What's the job of the head judge there?
The head judge is just to make sure everything's in shape before you hit enter. He sees all the scores from all the judges up there. Just make sure that there's nothing wacky or a fat finger.
All right, here we go. The muscle back in the park. This is Chris Russell from Hermosa Beach, California. Let's see it, Russell.
Is he going to try the frontside air revert again? There it is. And he washes out again. That's the third time he's had the exact same slam. I wonder if he's going to try that again. He's got so many tricks in that line.
He could do a boneless. We saw him do lip slide Smith grind in practice.
Did he just say right here? Right here. I got it.
I love it. That's like when you're filming.
Look at his front truck. Look at that. It's barely hanging on.
Yeah, when you're filming with your buddy and you're like, right here, I got it.
I got it.
Chris Russell, frontside air revert, carving 20 feet right here.
There we go.
Perfect. What's he going to do? Full speed backwards, does a 180 in the flat.
Now we're in for it. Chris Russell.
There's the front invert. I've been talking about it all day. That is such a gnarly line.
Stay
out
on.
Of the deep
Stay
end.
On.
Over the hip to front invert on the extension. That is so gnarly.
17 seconds. Chris Russell still dropping hammers.
Back into the deep end. Full speed frontside air to tail. Frontside boneless disaster. This is the run that Chris Russell wanted. Frontside air revert. Smacking it to Smith. Is this going to be the winning run? Wow. One-footed eggplant at time.
Oh, my.
That
wildness.
Run was insane.
Everybody is losing it, including us. So, Neil, what got into Chris Russell right there?
Yeah, you know, he was practicing that run in you know, the last few days. Didn't bring it out till the finals. Can't wait to see the replay of that frontside invert transfer out of the deep end. But how about that for just 91?
A 91.99. Chris Russell breaks into the excellent range and is your new leader.
But he did that frontside air revert after taking three slams in a row. That is confidence. I mean, most guys, he's got 10 other tricks that he could do to try and do that line.
There's
Boneless
your top
revert.
Five.
He could do the lip slide Smith grind, but he wanted to do that frontside air revert.
Now, I was going to accuse him of being stubborn right there, but I'm glad he is because, man, he fought that trick and he won. Ronnie Sandoval now, he's been in the same position, answering back after a crazy run by Chris Russell. Here we go, Ronnie Sandoval. He needs a 92 to break into the lead.
Ronnie got bumped down to sixth place, but we have seen that Ronnie can hang with the best of them in the semifinals in Melbourne. He had the best score out of everyone. Finger flip, lean to tail. That was massive. Love that floaty backside ollie. That deep end is so hard, it doesn't even go to vert. It is so tricky to not hang up on airs.
Spending a lot of time in the flat, which just eats time away from you.
Still got 10 seconds to go, back for the hip. What's he got?
Winding up for something.
Wow, looked like he was going for a super carved lean to tail.
Currently sitting in sixth place.
Yeah, I think
Ronnie Sandoval.
He had a 66.90. I think that will improve his score for sure. Not sure how far it's going to bump him up.
Waiting for scores. Next skater up will be Tom Shaw. Yeah, you're right. He did improve a 69.33, but it just does enough to keep him in sixth place. Tom Shaw. Fully focused. Will he switch his run up or we go to the tried and true bangers?
Wow. Looked like he was going for a kickflip frontside air, maybe a kickflip stalefish, not sure. Either way, he's got a rebate coming.
First wall rebates for everybody in the finals. That's their gift for battling through and to get here.
I love it. It makes the level skating and the runs that they try so much harder.
Absolutely. Tom Shaw, back at it.
And when you drop in and make one of those amazing tricks when you're on the first wall, it just gives you insane confidence that hopefully you can carry through the rest of your run. Love that backside ollie. That is
that's
literally,
his biggest one yet.
Yeah, that's like a head-high backside ollie on that extension.
I can't breathe. It's crazy.
Is he going to go for the five right here? Missed his pump a little bit. Still got the five.
A fan favorite. They love 540s, don't they?
Back D revert. See if he finishes with that front blunt again. Nope. Back into the shallow end.
5 seconds. How's he going to finish this, Neil?
Wow. Backside 360. That's a new one for Tom. That was a super good run.
Go get your hat.
Wow. Kickflip burial. I think that's going to be in the range of Tristan Rennie. Tristan Rennie has an 82.74 in third. I think that's going to be fighting for a podium spot with Tristan.
Now, what do you think? Had he pulled that first frontside flip, what would that add to his score?
Oh, yeah, he'd be mid-80s for sure.
All right, Tom Schaar waiting for the score. He needs a 92 to crack into that leading spot,
yeah,
held currently by Chris Russell.
To me, that's super, yep, third place.
Hey, you're good, Neil.
A little bit ahead of Tristan. You know, Tom had the 540 in the deep end. Tristan did the 540 over the hip. So pretty similar scores for Tom Schaar in third. Tristan Rennie now in fourth.
Tom and Tristan no doubt have tangled in past competitions. Here goes Tristan Rennie.
Yeah, Tom and Tristan been doing battle also in the combi pool at the Vans pool party the last couple years. Tristan took the win at Vans pool party in 2014. Tom Schaar took the win in 2015.
Oh, Tristan almost missing his tail. He got here in the deep end.
Gosh, that Indy disaster is so fast. Ollie to pivot onto the hip, out of the deep.
We're at 10 seconds now. He's got to finish strong.
Want to see that nose grind again. Boneless disaster into the corner. Another super good run for Tristan Rennie.
So solid. That fall was before time. So Tristan Rennie now. It looks like he's kind of focusing in. He's trying to battle with Tom Schaar.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to improve his score. He didn't do the nose grind. I know the judges love that one. I think Tristan's 82.74 is still going to be his top score.
It's not just Tristan waiting for scores either. It's Curran Capels. You know, with every score that comes through, you kind of have a self-regulating method where you go, okay, I need to better that score. Here we go, Curran Capels.
Wow.
No need on the first wall rebate for Curran Capels.
Perfect nose grind, nollie out.
This dude has wings. He is flying around this park.
Wow. What a run for Curran. Perfect back nose blunt, but takes it to the shoulder.
Oh, I just want to punch a wall.
Gosh,
that was an amazing run.
Starting the run with the frontside flip. He knew that he had first wall rebate as the safety net.
Goes down hard, trying to bring it all back in. You see Curran Capels walking off. You can tell a little bit of pain right there. You got a free neck adjustment right there for that slam. Waiting for scores, Curran Capels. And I'm wondering if he's all right. He walked off the deck, 77.47. For Curran Capels, it's enough to get him into fifth place. Man, this park has been taking a toll on some of our skaters, and this guy has taken the brunt of it. Ben Hatchell skating with a dislocated shoulder. He's got 45 seconds, Neil.
Is he gonna go for the 540 transfer again? There it is, make it, under-rotated. Like we said, he's got a separated shoulder. It's so hard to be fully committed to taking a slam. We saw him make it a couple runs ago. But after that, Ben Hatchell hasn't been able to put together his full 45 seconds, still sitting down in eighth place.
Ben Hatchell, a past winner here in Huntington. How's he gonna start this run on his rebate?
Back to the back tail, try and put a solid 45 together.
I like that his plan B is that
I know.
Yeah. Back tail.
Isn't it good to have a bunch of plans? Cab disaster on the 8 foot wall is so solid. Frontside hurricane on the extension.
Ben Hatchell, a literal mini ramp champ.
Yeah, looked like he went for the front feeble, didn't quite get the front truck over. Look at this, frontside flip. Oh my gosh, how did he even get that under his feet?
His board was in Newport Beach.
Yeah.
And somehow he reached out and grabbed it. Almost,
just like
almost made it.
Almost squatted out. Kickflip, frontside grab, out of the deep end, all the way over the hip.
That was looking like the run he wanted. Ben Hatchell on his third run is in eighth
place. If he starts with a 540 and is able to do that trick, that could be in the 90s.
The scores come in for Ben Hatchell. Oscar Rosenberg Halberg getting ready. We call him Oski. And he's making a name for himself around the world through video parts and through skating hard in the Vans Park Series.
I don't think he expected to use first wall rebate on a stale fish on the extension, I'll tell you that.
See where he chooses drop. He's just going to go ahead from right there. Working his ray around the deck. He's going to roll it in.
What? No complied tail slide.
I wasn't
drop
ready for
in.
That. Oh, my God.
That right there was just an afterthought for Oski, and that was like one of the coolest tricks we've seen all week.
That'll be on ThrasherMagazine.com for sure.
I think Oski's just having fun right now. He's currently in second place, has a monster score. Don't know if feels like he can improve on that, so he's just flying around, giving us a treat for the fans.
He's giving us a lesson in stylish skateboarding. Here's what to do, kids.
Wow, alley-oop, back D. That is control, back nose blunt in the deep end.
I've not seen that
yet. Yeah, maybe he could improve his score after all. That run was sick.
Oscar Rosenberg Halberg currently sitting in second place. Hoping to break into the 90s with that last run. Everybody staring up at the video screen wondering what are the judges gonna throw out there. He needs a 92 for first. He's battling right now with Chris Russell. They see on the deck. Sportsmanship right there.
That's so rad. That's skateboarding.
That's
right
rad.
There.
An 80.01. Not quite there. Still good enough to be in second place though.
Still has one more run. He's already put two scores in the 80s on the board.
Murillo Perez currently in sixth place. His highest score as of yet is 75.40. He's hoping to improve. Here we go. Are we going to see a run in the 90s from Murillo?
Full speed attack from Murillo Perez. Backsmith up into back tail. Body jar on the extension. Now carving frontside for speed. Look at that stale fish carved so far into the corner. Sets him up for a tricky line for the hip.
Well, he's definitely got the best stale fish award so far.
Look at this, man. This is a really good run. Back tail in the deep end. We could have another guy in the 80s. Oh, you know what that was? I've seen him practice that line, and he decided not to do the stale fish disaster that he slammed on a couple runs ago.
I wouldn't either.
Yeah, no kidding. He took a stale fish disaster to the head, and I think at the last second he decided to do a different trick. It's hard to switch it up when you've been practicing a line for a few days.
Waiting for scores for Murillo Perez. His high right now is 75.40. It's going to be right under there, but I mean, look at the consistency there. 60 yeah. plus on every run. That's
if he
solid.
Can just make that last 10 seconds of his run, he's in the 80s and potentially on the podium.
Man, I'm getting sore just watching these guys battle. Chris Russell is in the park. Your current leader with 45 seconds. Here we go.
It gets really weird when he's in the lead. That's a first wall rebate. That was going to be an alley-oop 50-50 lip slide to Smith grind.
Jeez.
At Mach 10.
He is beat up, man. Look at, he is just bruised and battered. It's one thing to, you know, skate wearing pants and a shirt, but skate in just trunks, hey, that's heavy.
It doesn't hurt when you look at the scoreboard and see that you're in first place. It doesn't hurt at all. Oh my gosh, it was a boneless. I think he was trying to decide if it was gonna go to revert or straight in. Either way, early fall for Chris Russell.
All right, here we go. Neil Hendricks, we are staring down the barrel of what could be a new leader. Final runs. We're going to start with Ronnie Sandoval. He's done it in the past. Can he do it again? Can he recreate his magical run from Melbourne? Here we go with 45 seconds. Ronnie Sandoval.
The mechanic going to work. Love that carving Madonna on the extension. See a lot of guys do that trick, but you don't see a lot of guys carve it like that. Laying down the hand on the backsmith. Look at that Smith vert. That is textbook with the toe on the tail.
20 seconds.
This could be Ronnie's best run we've seen. Wow, perfect lean air in the deep. Frontside air transfer onto the hip. 10 seconds to go.
Come on, Ronnie. I want to see that frontside invert.
What's he got? Oh, he got a little bit lost just at the end.
Ronnie Sandoval, hey, you made the finals. Congratulations. Right now, sitting in seventh place, always a pleasure to watch Ronnie Sandoval skate.
It is, and I cannot wait to see him in Malmo in 3 weeks. He's one of our Vans Pro Park Series Select Pros, so he's guaranteed to be in the World Championships in Malmo.
And there you have it, a 65.87. He's going to hang in there now at seventh place. Big high fives from all the homies on the deck. All right, it all comes down to this. Fourth and final run for Tom Schaar. Does he have what it takes to win? He needs a 92 or above.
Look at that foot setup, going for a kickflip lean melon. You saw him setting up for the kickflip. Hasn't worked out for Tom on the first wall rebate, but start the clock. Give that one a second chance.
Is he going to go stale fish or is he going to try that kickflip?
I think he goes back for the stale fish. I think he knows that he can clean the end of his run up a little bit, get that front blunt in there, get the 540. I think he goes safe and goes stale fish.
The most psycho safe trick ever.
Yeah, no
that
kidding.
That was a crazy
one. I wish
one.
That was my safety trick.
So this run could mean he's punched his ticket to Malmo. He's got 28 seconds to go.
Yeah, he was in fifth place in the challenger ranking.
Oh, no.
Crooks to fakie. That was a new one. I think Tom was going for that crooks to fakie transfer from bowl to bowl.
Well, as if he didn't have enough fans already. He's just won over this entire Huntington Beach crowd. Tom Schaar looking good qualification. But again, we're taking from the whole series.
Yeah, it's from the whole series. But I think he's pretty safe. Book that ticket, Tom.
Tristan Rennie now with 45 seconds.
Wow, different line.
Oh, that was heavy.
That's the first time I've seen him start up in the shallow end, hit the deep with a lot of speed for that nose grind.
Back at it, first wall rebate, time resets. Tristan Rennie is rolling.
Love that quick tail smack on the frontside grab. Pumping for speed, backside transfer, dip in the backsmith. Oh, the 540 over the hip. That's the first time I've seen him bail on that one all week.
All right, Tristan Rennie, his score comes through. A throwaway final run for Tristan. He's in fourth place. Curran Capel's coming back from a major slam.
Wow, that frontside flip in the deep end is so sick. Made that last run. Didn't work out this time, but he gets a restart.
All right, first wall rebate. Here we go again, Curran Capel.
He's going for it again, and it doesn't work.
I think he's in pain, man.
Yeah.
That slammed, I think that was worse than it looked.
Yeah, that was a heavy one he took on run number three.
And we're working our way through the list. Ben Hatchell's currently sitting in eighth place. Here's your top five as it stands now. Chris Russell hanging on the lead. Oski in second, Tom Schaar in third place. Tristan Rennie in fourth, Curran Capels in
fifth. We have two skaters that are not on that leaderboard, Ben Hatchell and Murillo Perez. Still could bump into the lead, still could bump into the podium. We saw the tricks that Ben Hatchell was trying, that 540 transfer, the kickflip frontside air out of the deep. If Hatchell makes all that stuff, he could be in the 90s.
Here we go. Last chance for Ben Hatchell. He is a past winner. Does he have what it takes to take the title back?
Commit, Ben. Yes! Squatted out of it. He made the 540 to start the run.
And he's got to stay on for 32 more seconds and there's fill the park with tricks.
Cap disaster again. This is the run that Ben wanted. Lip slide on the extension. He's got to do the kickflip frontside air transfer out of the deep end. Look at this. No tricks in the deep end. Just pumping for speed. Look at this gap. Kickflip frontside air. He made it!
Oh,
are you kidding me?
My. Ben Hatchell
he
is
He won
heavy.
His contest last year when it was Van Doren Invitational. Could he win it again? One more trick. Frontside air revert. That run was insane.
Wow, that's time for Ben Hatchell fighting through the pain.
That blunt
that one's for the fans.
Making after time. He did all that with a separated shoulder. One of the gnarliest runs we've ever seen in Vans Park Series history.
The crowd is losing it.
How do you judge that against Chris Russell? Chris Russell was full speed aggression. That was just super tech, flipping his board, doing a 540. Is that gonna beat Chris Russell?
Never count out Ben Hatchell. That was the heaviest run we've seen him
throw
down.
We did not know if he could skate today. He was in the hospital with a separated shoulder 48 hours ago. Second place, Russell still on top.
Wow, Ben Hatchell hammers up into second place. We now hear. It's all up to Oscar.
I heard some boos in the crowd. I knew that was going to be close.
Man, don't write anything down because things are changing. Oscar Rosenberg Hallberg,
hey,
skater from Sweden.
He's
final
still
looks
on the podium. He's in third place right now. No one had Oski slotted in for a podium. What? I thought he was going to go 360 on that. Backside grab to Indy. Last run for Oski.
I love the windup he gets. Man, the photographers and filmers on the deck are getting hammered right now. Oscar Rosenberg Hallberg currently sitting in third place. Two more skaters yet to go.
Great
Murillo
skating.
Perez and Chris Russell.
Hey, congratulations, Oski. No matter where he ends up, we're going to his hometown in 3 weeks. Stoked to see Oski put it together. Got a Swede on the podium right now if it ended.
Oscar Rosenberg Hallberg currently sitting in third place. Murillo Perez, we know he's got the speed. We know he's got the blast ability. Does he have the consistency to hang on?
This is the last skater that could unseat Chris Russell. The last shot.
He's fired up. Murillo Perez from Brazil. Here we go.
Wow, backsmith to tail slide. In practice, I saw him doing back tail revert over that transfer. He's got to do everything he knows to try and unseat Chris Russell. Wow, that stalefish floating
so
deep
lofty
into the corner.
So far, so good. 20 seconds left.
Popping out of the Smith grind. Backsmith in the deep end. Look at this line. That is so sick.
Do is not run do out of gas.
Stale disaster. That's what took him out on run number two. He's on it.
7 seconds to go. Back in the deep end.
Oh, my gosh. We got another run. Made the front feeble. Front invert disaster. That was right at time. I don't think he planned on going to disaster. I think he was just completely hung up on the frontside invert. Had to try and do everything he could to make it.
Now, Neil, if this happens, this will be the first time we will see three select pros on the podium. We've got one more run to come from Chris Russell. Now we're waiting for a super important score from Murillo Perez. He has just skated his heart out. You see right there, giving it up to the crowd.
Chris Russell wins, 80.69, slots into sixth place. Chris Russell's gonna take a victory lap. The first skater to win two Vans Park Series events.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are witnessing the victory lap of the one and only Chris the Muscle.
Bonus revert, are you kidding me? Look at this run. Let's see if we see that frontside invert again. Tail grab, nose bonk revert. That's just for fun. He gets the big check. Congratulations, Chris Russell.
Our first ever double winner on the Vans Park Series for 2016. Chris Russell, he's been keeping it clean, keeping it lean and mean in the park. He is your champion.
He's been keeping it clean, but the party starts now. Look at that. That is so cool. His grandparents are in the crowd cheering him on here in Huntington Beach.
Let's go down to the deck and get the vibe going with Chris Pastras.
Chris Russell, I'm speechless, man. Describe the stoke you're feeling right now.
Dude, I can't even believe it myself, man. Everybody ripped it out of here so hard. I'm just so stoked to be in this contest with everybody. So, dude, I feel blessed, man. I'm so hyped. Oh, man, I can't even explain it.
And you got off to a little bit of a rocky start with that frontside air revert. You kept trying it, kept trying it. What was up with that vendetta you had with that trick?
I was just going to try to stick with it and being like, I don't know, just got to go for it, put it all on the line, you know, and ended up working, so I'm stoked, man. I'm glad I kept with it. But took a few diggers the first time, but yeah, here now.
And what was going through your mind when Ben Hatchell took that run?
Dude, I was unreal. Insanity, dude. So sick. I thought he was going to bump me out, truthfully. But, like, he fucking absolutely destroyed it on, like, every level. Went everywhere, used the whole park, you know, it was so insane.
And you've been a crowd favorite all weekend long. You got any words for our crowd and our web viewers out here?
Hey, thanks for coming out, everybody. Another epic event. Thank you, Van Dorn. Thank you, Vans. Thank everybody. Thanks for my family for supporting, and cheers. Let's do it up. Let's celebrate.
Yes, congratulations, Chris Russell, 2016 Vans Park Series Huntington Beach. Congrats, brother. We're taking a short break.
Welcome back and congratulations, Chris Russell. And look at all the stories we have to tell after this amazing Vans Park Series final. Ben Hatchell, 48 hours ago, was at the hospital getting diagnosed with a separated shoulder. Just made an insane run, ended up with an 89.10, barely missing out on the win, but taking home second place. And how about Oscar Rosenberg Hallberg, our kid from Malmo. We're going there in 3 weeks, and he's going to his hometown fresh off a podium finish at the Vans Park Series here in Huntington Beach. Tom Schar, he was one of our challengers trying to make it into the World Championships with a fourth place result. He's going to Malmo. We got to crunch the numbers to see if Tristan Rennie and Murillo Perez have qualified, because the results for the challengers are from all four stops. It was originally going to be the top five with the injuries. Now we're taking eight of the challengers to Malmo. So now it's time to crunch some numbers. But that is our final result from here in Huntington Beach. We're gearing up for our awards right now. We're also going to follow up with a best trick contest. These best trick contests here at the Vans Park Series have produced some of the best skating we have seen at all of the stops. If you saw the highlight reels from Hastings Skate Park in Vancouver a couple weeks ago, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Sky Siljic, Grayson Fletcher, Riley Boland, all those guys did some insane tricks in the best trick contest. But right now, we got to give away some big checks and some big money and cool trophies. And then it's best trick madness. We're going to throw it down to Chris Cote to give some awards. Take it away, Chris.
Right on. Thank you, Neil and Pastris, up in the booth. Yo, I want to give it up. Huntington Beach, did you like what you saw today? Hell yes. Where are our friends and fans from Hermosa Beach? You must be psyched. Yeah, there they are. All right, now let's get down to it. Let's do the business of giving out the hardware. Of course, we are super hyped to be a part of the Vans U.S. Open of Surfing going on all week. We're down to it here on a Saturday. And this event, I have to say, you guys have borne witness to the best event yet on the Vans Park Series. Thank you, Huntington Beach, for being a part of this series. And man, my mind is blown from some of the skating we just saw. We gotta thank, of course, our friends and family at Vans, WSL, IMG, The Border for putting this together, Thrasher Magazine, the city of Huntington Beach, the athletes, the fans, and you gotta give it up one more time for all the skaters. We went from 100, pared it down to 9 and 20 today, an incredible finals in the books. And it wouldn't be a contest, it wouldn't be a party without the hardest working man in action sports. Introducing the one and only Mr. Steve Van Doren.
All right. Thank you very much. First of all, Huntington Beach, thank you for letting us build this great bowl of cement on your beach here 4 years ago. We had a dream. And thank you very much for WSL, IMG, Joe from California Skate Parks, who built this. It wouldn't be true unless you let us do this, first of all. But it's turned into the Vans Park Series. This is stop four, heading off to Malmo, Sweden. But thank you, skaters. Let's hear it again. I didn't hear a great enough laughter out there. Come on, let's hear some cheers for the skaters. They just gave us 4 hours of entertainment. But thank you very much. Everybody have a great day. Thanks for coming out to the Vans US Open of Surfing.
All these skateboarders paid for it with blood, sweat, heart, and soul. At the end of the day, we will be awarding the top three skateboarders here in Huntington Beach. It's been a long run all the way from Melbourne, Australia, and competing in each and every event all the way from Malmö, Sweden. In third place, Oscar Rosenberg Hallberg. Give it up for Oski. Oski, one of our Vans Select pros, and I think we made a good choice in Oski right behind me. Give it up one more time for Oscar. Yes, nobody paid more dues than this next guy. Skating with a dislocated shoulder, grimacing through the pain, ripping all the way to the finals, and absolutely destroying his last run. Give it up for Ben Hatchell. Ben Hatchell, this dude is an absolute warrior. And folks, we knew he was gonna be a threat coming into this contest. A lot of people picking him as a favorite. And those people were right. I'd like to bring up to the stage your winner of the Vans Park Series, Huntington Beach from Hermosa Beach, Chris the Muscle Russell! These are your three finalists. 1, 2, and 3. Get your photos now. These guys are going to Sweden for our global championships. One more word from our champ, Chris Russell, Chris the Muscle Russell, first place again on the Park Series. Give it up one more time for your fans out there.
Yep, yep, HB, what's up?
These are your winners, 1, 2, 3. One more time for Vans Park Series, Huntington. Hey, the skate party's not over. Best trick is about to go down. This is gonna be the heaviest best trick contest of the year by far. Do not go anywhere. More action to come live from Huntington Beach. You're watching the Vans Park Series. Back to you guys in the booth.
Thank you, Chris Cote. We're up here crunching numbers. Everyone's got the computers and the calculators fired up. We're trying to figure out who's going to Malmo. We started out with 15 Park Series Select Pros. We went to 4 stops to find the 5 challengers. Along the way, we lost Colin Provost. He can't go to Malmo. Riley Hawk and Rowan Zarilla both broke their ankles, had to get surgery. Hope you guys get well soon. So now we have 8 spots going to Malmo among the challengers. So right now, we're crunching the numbers. We went to Florianopolis, we went to Melbourne, we went to Vancouver, and now to Huntington Beach. There were some of the guys that went to all the stops, like Alex Sorgente, Tom Schar, Corey Juno, and there was a couple guys that might have missed a stop or two, but we're gonna let you know in just a few minutes who our top challengers were. Once again, congratulations to our podium today. Chris Russell in first, Ben Hatchell in second, Oscar Rosenberg Hallberg in third, and great skating from Tom Schar, Tristan Rennie, Murillo Perez, Curran Caples, and Ronnie Sandoval, all advancing into the top 8 for today's final. See the guys in the background right now warming up for our best trick contest. Can't believe that these guys are still able to skate. Right now, gonna throw it down to my buddy Chris Pastras. He's with Tom Schar.
So Tom, you're sitting 3rd in our rankings overall, got 4th place today. Not too shabby, buddy. So I guess describe this whole park terrain series for you. How's this experience been?
It's really fun. It's cool traveling to a bunch of different places with pretty much like all my friends. I don't know, it's rad. It's cool, like, how it works. It's like a kind of like a goal to work towards in the end, which is Malmo. So I'm hyped. I think I'm going, which is, I'm stoked.
What has been your favorite stop so far?
For sure this one. 100 guys in the contest. Like, I don't know how many people were in the crowds. It's been hectic. It's sick.
and you're now joining us in Stockholm, in Malmo, Sweden, excuse me. How motivating was that for you out here today?
I was like on the bubble to go as well, so I was just, I was just trying to up my score because I didn't do too well in Canada, so I'm just trying to do a little bit better.
It all came together. Congrats, Tom Schaar. Yeah. We will see you in Malmo, Sweden in just a few weeks. Yes! Thank you, guys. Back to you.
Thank you, Chris Pastris, and congratulations, Tom Schaar. You are going to be going to Malmo for our first World Championships of Park Terrain Skateboarding. Going to throw it back down to the deck of the park for our boys from the border. We're going to check out Best Trick. It's going to get nuts.
Back Smith. Pedro Delfino getting in there. Robin Bolian. Oh, Sky going for that back Smith rock and roll slide.
Hey, Tim, we're live to the web, man. Finally.
Oh, we're on the internet.
Finally, I get to talk to my friends at home. We're live to the web.
Live to the web right now. We got Colin Graham out there. I know warming up for the best trick.
I know I got some good homies back in Tampa watching right now.
Oh, my God. There goes the camera.
Hey,
that was pretty sick.
Hey, why don't we get money. Can we get Danny Way out here in Best Trick? I mean, I know
shoot him out
there. I know he's Danny Way's over there sitting down. I really like to see him grab someone's board.
Shoot that perfect American out there.
He is the best. You got to love Danny Way. He's been out here. Andrew Reynolds was here watching the other day.
Colin McKay's here today.
Oh, yeah, I saw Colin out there today. What's up? What's up, Ronnie?
Yeah, Sky Siljeg out there.
Who's doing the kickflip indy?
Cedric Tristan Pappy. Rennie going for the overcrooks.
Cedric, get that kickflip in, you goddammit.
Cedric Pavich is taking over the kickflip indie for Ronnie Sandoval.
All right, fair enough. Oh, yes, looking so sick of that Cedric Pavich.
It looked really good, too. Get it, Cedric.
Doing a drifter style, like tweaked out. Nose slide to fakie.
Hey, Josh, we got $20 for that nose slide fakie. That's a start.
The overcrooks pop out right there. We'll give you 20 for that. 20 for the two of you guys. Robin Bolian just launching right there. I love how everybody now has learned how to bail out and just turn into a limp body and just let yourself slide down the transition.
Hey, Tim, you can't see it on the webcast, but behind us in the deep bowl is Ashad Ware just skating around, just kind of saying that.
Tom Schaar, come over here, crooked grind to fakie, over the love seat.
There you go, Tom.
Over the love seat. Got Marlon Silva out there. Pedro Delfino, fast plant all the way across.
Gave that $20 to Tom Schaar.
Colin Graham building up some speed.
I love when that money's just burning a hole in my pocket all weekend, Jason, and we get to give it away during Best Trick at the end of the weekend. It's too fun.
It's like that movie, Brewster's Millions. Just got to give away money. Man, like
we were just talking about that in the office the other day, and the younger people that work in the office didn't know the movie.
Fair enough.
Shows my age.
Oh, Marlon going for the fakie Smith all the way across. Sky Siljeg out there. The magic maker.
Holy, whoa.
He tried to kill him.
Robin Bolian trying to take him out.
Chucking his board.
I mean, if anything ever happened to Sky, he would just probably magically disappear and reappear somewhere else anyway.
Yo, that was insane right there. Huge indie tuck me.
Got some money for you over here, Colin Graham. I got $20. Oh, he's going for the kickflip indie as well.
Switching it up right there. Yeah, Colin, we got 20 for you.
This will help Colin Graham's monthly fee to get his spray tan.
There you go. Oh, my God!
What was it?
Aaron front invert over the whole thing. So close to making it.
Wow.
That is a psycho.
Jason, how much are you giving for that?
Watch.
That's Pedro Delfino.
Keep watching.
Pedro.
Oh, my God.
Pedro.
That is psycho.
That
what the hell on earth?
Completely insane.
What the?
How much, Jason, how much money you got for that? 170. All right, you're just making up numbers. $170, Pedro, coming your way.
Oh, the backspin, the rock and roll slice shuffle out. Sky Siljeg.
Hey, Jason really likes Sky because he just gave him $70 for that one. Yeah, Sky.
Yeah, Cedric Pavich going for that kickflip Indy. Oh, right behind him, Colin Graham giving it a whirl too. Josh Borden going for a cab to something.
Yo, this is completely insane right here. Pedro Delvino
right now. You've got to be kidding me!
Oh, my God.
What the hell just happened?
Oh, what?
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 Pedro Delvino, I think we're all going to remember that all year long. Pedro, come up here and get this $220 for me. Wow, my man.
Yo, Pedro.
That was amazing.
Holy.
You're welcome.
Thank you for doing that.
Wow. He told Jason Rothmeyer he didn't really have anything for best trick.
Yeah, right. The most ludicrous trick ever.
How is that even?
I can't think of anything harder than that.
That was insane.
Like, how do you try it? How do you bail out of it? Like, I don't get it.
Hey, man, I love when Grayson joins the best trick.
Yes.
I love it.
The Wolf joining the Wolf Pack.
We got Josh Borden.
Going for a back lip, trying to get something out of that, probably.
I don't know what Marlon's going for.
Oh, for the alley-oop, 5-0.
Alley-oop rewind, 5-0, whatever. Yep. I don't know. I'm just making up names at this point, Tim.
Yeah, either or.
Got Robin Bolian. Tom Sharp following him. Nope. What's he going for here?
I don't know, but he's cooking. Alley-ooping his life away. Yeah, Marlon.
That's a good one.
Kimbo on. Slice of skateboarding.
I'd like to see Cedric Pavich land that. Now, what's Pedro going to do now?
Get out of here, yo. Upgrading?
Really? I didn't think that was upgradable.
I didn't think the first one was going to totally be possible. I was like, maybe. Whoa! Tom Shark over the Ollie 540.
Jason, how much are you giving for that? Ollie 540 over that. Just give him the rest of the money and we can end it? That would be pretty messed up. I want to see Sky do some more tricks because
he's got a million more for sure.
Such a pleasure to watch.
Yeah, Marlon.
I want to see that one, Marlon.
Frontside alley-oop 50-50.
That was sick, but we've seen it all day, so. Yeah. That's not going to get it.
Yeah, if we've seen it all day, you're not going to get it. Oh, my God. The way he's doing it is insanity.
That is completely nuts.
Marlon!
Whoa.
Marlon Silva!
My man.
The Fakie alley-oop 5-0 to Fakie.
So, so buttery right there. My man Marlon Silva. $50 for him.
Pedro Delfino right back in there. Oh, oh my God!
That does
not even make sense. That's like some monkey. That's a monkey business.
Tim, how much to try that? Like, Tim, I'm gonna try it.
Never.
Fully committed.
My arm would snap in half. Everything would pop off of my body. It would be a yard sale of all my appendages. And Daniel Vargas in there.
He's getting his body around.
Yep.
It's doable.
It's possible.
Tim, we might run out of money once we turn this around going the other way.
Yeah, and if that happens, that's okay.
Yep.
That means it was worth it. Yeah, we've been going at this for almost 9 minutes. Oh my Lord.
It's shocking. It is absolutely shocking that he's seriously trying that.
Marlon Silva going up, fakie again. Oh, going up for the switch, Smith. Sky Siljak, oh yes, going for the back lip, popping in early.
I'm the biggest Sky fan.
Yeah, nice blunt slide. We've seen it in the contest though, so we're not giving money for that one.
Yeah, we saw that quite a bit in the contest. Not quite a bit, we saw a few people do it.
Oh, I like the Aaron Fakie though.
Aaron Fakie will get you something.
Yeah, Daniel Vargas going for the shove it, nose slide.
That'll definitely get you something.
Oh.
Oh my God, switch front 50-50 yeah. Over that whole thing.
Sick.
How much you want to give, Jason? Oh, he's trying to switch fifth? Yeah. Oh, okay.
Oh,
okay.
Sky Siljak taking a bit of a digger, but.
So, okay, we're going to give a chance to do the switch Smith. I didn't figure that one out. Thank you, Jason.
Oh my God, that's like a, almost doing like a backflip.
Pedro's an animal. All the other skaters are over here high-fiving him. Everyone wants to see that, Tim.
Bonkers.
Yeah, oh, my
Marlon
God.
Silva, get up here.
Wow.
We got money for you.
Marlon.
Switch Smith grind all the way across.
Marlon, cleaning up over here. Another $50 for you, my man. Yes, sir.
Tom Shar, you lunatic.
Dude, he is getting close. He is getting close. Tim, it's only, I mean, I'm sure the webcast announcers covered this, but it's a matter of time before Tom Shar is winning these contests. Like,
yeah.
It's coming.
He's still such a young gun.
Yeah, yeah, just beginning. Whoa, the air to fakie.
He's only just begun to dabble in puberty, as I like
yeah,
to say
yeah,
often.
Very
know?
Well put, very well put.
Like, if he got arrested, he goes to juvie. Weird.
Juvie, yeah, that's right. That's a good point. Never thought of that.
Oh my God, that is insane. A new spider monkey of a human being.
It really is, man. It really is. We'll probably give like a few more tries going this way. What do you think, Tim? And then kind of switch it up?
Yes.
Because I'd like to see that. I'd like to see the air to fakie. Oh, you know what? We have
I
want to
see the 540 ollie.
Yeah, we got kind of a lot of tricks. I was underestimating how
Keep
much we have here.
Keep it going for a few more minutes. Oh, getting close to that kickflip Indy right there, Colin Graham.
I got a word
for
that.
Oh, my God.
I got a word for Colin that I can't say over the webcast right now. We're here because he had that under his feet, and he completely just moved his board out of the way.
He pussy willowed out of it.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, there you go.
Pussy willows. I love that plan.
Please don't do it again, Colin. Just land it.
Ah, so close, close.
He's got it coming.
Yo, the Mexican spider monkey. I don't even know if he's Mexican, but.
I don't think he's Mexican.
Whatever.
No.
His first name's Pedro. As a white guy.
Delfino? That's like Italian. He's probably, I don't know. I don't know what Pedro is. I never asked him. I mean, why bring racism into front and invert reverse? I mean, it's not necessary.
It's not racism. Ethnically aware. Oh, yeah, Tristan Rennie going for that air to fakie. Doing a little shifty. As a honky, I feel like it shows that you are open to not calling everybody the basic thing.
Whoa, the board's making it around. Let's see it, Tom Shar. All right, Cedric. So let's do three tries each on all this and then switch it around, all right?
Three tries more for each of these guys?
I gotta throw some pressure on you guys because you're not landing it. So here's the first one for Pedro. Three more tries, first try right here.
Oh my Lord have mercy, what are you?
What are you gonna give him? Another 220, so there you go, you got 440, my man.
Oh
yeah,
my
Pedro.
God, oh, Tom Shar getting closer to that one.
Wow.
He didn't need three more tries, he only needed one more.
Yeah, that's one for Tom.
Yeah, Marlon.
Here comes Colin for his first attempt.
Oh, kickflip Indy. What the hell?
No.
You glazed golden
there you go.
Man.
We got 70 for Colin right there. Yeah, Colin, nice job, my man.
Sky Siljak, you spaz. I love you.
He's the best. He is the best.
The human hacky sack.
He probably can hacky sack really good.
Devil sticks. Kills it on the conga drums.
All right, Marlon Silva right here. Going for that switch nose grind. All right, that's two for Marlon. Sky's on his second right here.
Yeah, going for that back lip, popping in wall ride style. No
Tom's on his
right
second.
There. Wow, that 540, whoa. It's insane how it stays on his feet. Tristan Rennie going for that air to fakie.
He's got some hand time.
All right, we're going to cut into the madness for a special alert. That's right, we've got our finalists set. The first ever global championships for Vans Park Series in Malmo, Sweden. It's right around the corner. Chris Cote here with Neil Hendricks. I feel like I'm coming down from like climbing Mount Everest or something. That was incredible.
Yeah, how do you think those guys on the deck of the park feel?
They're probably in pain. I'm in psych mode. Let's take a look at the top eight challengers. These are all the skaters advancing to Malmo, starting with. Let's start from the bottom, and I'll let you tell me your thoughts. Tristan Rennie.
Yeah, great skating. Sealed the deal today with a top five. Alex Sorgente wasn't able to skate the qualifying round yesterday. Got a Charlie horse in his leg. Had a collision with Sky Siljig, but he still was able to advance with three top 10 finishes. Tom Schaar went to every stop and ended with his best result here in Huntington Beach, fourth place. Corey Juneau, two times he was in the top five. He's going to Malmo, and Yvonne Federico, even though he missed Australia, has a first place and a second place in Canada and Brazil. He's joining us in Malmo.
And the good news for Yvonne Federico, he's got a lot of time to recuperate. Robin Bolian, Colin Graham, Vinicius Coquino got in.
Yeah, that's so cool. And he only made the semifinals once, but we added in the points also from the qualifying day. V barely missed the cut in Melbourne and also had a really good result in the qualifying day in Huntington Beach. V Coquinho is going to Malmo.
Those are your skaters that got the golden ticket to Malmo. Now one of you at home is gonna get this little gold nugget. I'm talking about the Kyle Walker, brand new pro model shoe, waffle cup. I mean, we're talking ultra cush. This thing, I've skated in it personally. It is a gem on your feet. And Neil, since this is your personal shoe now, here you go.
Thank
you. I'm gonna let you announce the winner.
Yes, check it out. Tunnel Dog Clips.
Yeah, what's up, Tunnel Dog?
It looks like he's in New Mexico with the black flag board. Tunnel Dog Clips. You got some Kyle Walker Pro shoes coming to you. We're gonna DM you. It all goes down in the DM. We're gonna get your address and send you some Kyle Walker Pro shoes. Congratulations.
I'm going to follow him right now, too.
Yeah, thanks to everyone that hashtagged Vans Park Series. We always check them all out. Right now, we're going to check out Malmo.
Yeah, let's take a little trip to Malmo, Sweden. Check this out.
We're done, we did it, the park's finished, here it is. Vans Park Series final. It's gonna go down here and it's gonna be insane because this park is nuts. Whew. We're having the first session right now and it's scary, you're going so fast. So I don't know, gonna try and get some tricks in for you and show the park. Okay, we're here with P-Mag. What's up with this? This must be some kind of wrong. It's two pipes, it's supposed to be one.
Yeah, it's meant for the turbo grind.
Turbo grind. You got to go downhill super fast like this. Train track. We'll see if anybody can handle it.
Train.
Yeah. Okay, so we're here. We got the pool coping and the tile section. We get some good grinds. We got Will Taylor coming in here, coming in hot. Yeah! Viking blocks. Yeah, so in the middle we got a big, huge island with different hips on it. And like a mini mega jump and all kinds of weird shapes on that one. You can do huge airs and you can get a lot of speed from it. Major feature in the park. I think we're gonna see a lot of good stuff go down on that one.
Oh,
Okay, so Will, we're standing in front of the big, huge monster bank. Can you talk a little bit about that? What's that stuff up there?
Yeah, that thing's gnarly.
Right, so yeah, so we got quarter pipes on both sides of that. Both from the bottom and from the sides of the hip. And then we got the big wall on top of the wall. How, is there like a setback on that?
Yeah, about 15 centimeters, whatever that comes out. I don't know, six inches or so. That's what Oski wanted. I think it's going to be insane, man.
Yeah, so people are going to go up the huge bank and then up another bank and then down again. We'll see. But I'm sure they're gonna love that thing. It's going to be insane.
Wow, Psych Factor is next level, looking at that incredible park in Malmö, Sweden. We cannot wait to take this show on the road. The Global Championships will be coming right up. What's your first impression of that park?
Dude, that park is insane. I love seeing, you know, Fernando Bramsmark and Will Taylor and J-Mag skating that new park. Congratulations on building that amazing park, Dreamland and Brigoriette. Can't wait to see you guys in like 3 weeks. That park, I've seen the photos, I saw the construction. The end result looks even better than I imagined. These guys are gonna slay that park. I just wanna know, is anyone gonna do that transfer over the big bank from tranny to tranny?
It just got real watching that video. Well, check it out. Congratulations, of course, to Chris Russell on behalf of myself, Neil Hendricks, the whole production team down here at the Vans Pro Skate Park Series. Thank you so much for watching. You can take your helmets and your seatbelts off. This contest is over for now. But of course, we got more action coming live on the beach in Huntington Beach. Surf starting early AM tomorrow. BMX finals, it's all going down on Sunday. Thank you guys for watching.
Congratulations, Muscle!
Yeah. See you in Malmö.